setting up the stream. Alright. This should be good. We got two tournaments here. Both of them. My game of choice, PLO8. On this side, on the left, we have a $7 Hilo on demand. Basically a sit and go with late registration. We run typically pretty good in these. They're pretty turbo format. 5 minute levels, which I like as they end. And also, we start off with 1.5k chips, which moves the tournament along at a good pace. We did bust one of these earlier today, but we're gonna keep playing. And on the right over here, we have another tournament that we historically do pretty well in. The 200 guaranteed, $5 buy-in, rebuy on ignition. And that's all fine and dandy. Now, I did basically max late reg this, but the add-on chip is worth 5,000, which is very, very, very many chips. So, essentially, the average stack here is almost 3,000, but when you add 5,000 to that, which everyone's going to rebuy, the average stack is going to be, like, we're going to have, 6,000, and the average will be 8,000. And the blinds would be, 6,120, I think. So we're going to have plenty of big blinds, which is why I like max late regging this. We have plenty of big blinds. A lot of people get knocked out and don't re-enter, so there's a lot of dead money out there. So this is definitely one of the more value tournaments that you can get. See here, there's already $260 in the prize pool before add-ons. You can assume that everyone left, all 20 players that are left, are going to do the add-on because it's such a big add-on. It's a 5,000 chip add-on, which is very, very significant. So the prize pool is probably going to get increased by 5 times 20, so by $100. So we're looking at $360 in a 200 guarantee, which is pretty good. Hopefully they pay more than five spots, but that's okay. So even though I have kings here, I'm gonna fold just because risking our entire chip life with 10 big blinds, which might happen if I do decide to play this, is just gonna be super, super bad. Just because it's not worth risking a 1,000 chips. We also don't have a low draw, we don't have a nut high draw, we just have a pair of kings. So in this spot, I don't know, I'm starting to get to the point where I like to fold bad aces as well, which I think is a reasonable thing to do. Alright, over here we flop top pair, top kicker. There is a low out there, but I would like to bet and put pressure on this guy. He might call with just a worse king. He's also going to call with all of his made lows, and we pick up the pot, which is good. Now, these on-demand tournaments do have a very fast structure, so I'm pretty incentivized to play rather quick. Or, not quick, but aggressively. Alright, so here is the re-entry period. People can still late reg and get in here. I did it 5 minutes before the break just because I didn't want to screw up and forget to register or something, which would just be kind of sad. It should be offering me an add-on very soon, as soon as all the hands get done, I guess. There are three tables. We're going to add on. Double add-on? Can I double add-on? Oh, that'd be cool. Alright. So yeah. We're gonna have... 160 is gonna be the big blind. And we have 6,000 chips. So for max late regging, that is a significant amount of chips. I'm curious to see how big this prize pool is gonna get. I wouldn't be surprised if it goes over 400. This one is a slower structure than this one, 12 minute levels, which is pretty long, but I like our chances. Alright, so we pick up ace, three, queen, queen here. If it folds to us, I'm going to raise. This guy's big blind, this guy limping, I think limping might be too silly. I'm going to raise him and I'm not going to make it small. Something like this. If the big blind folds, that'd be cool. This hand does very well heads up. I have a pretty good low draw, second nut low draw. I also have a pair of queens. An ace on the flop wouldn't be great for us, but we also would make top pair in that case. And I guess I fold to any 3-bets. As stack preservation. Alright, pretty bad flop for us, but we're gonna check it. We probably have the best hand. Now, we do make an ace 3 low, but we're playing the 8, so there are a lot of lows that beat us. I think I'll check again. I wonder what hands this guy could bet that are for value. So he does pot it. So I'm wondering if he's going for a steal. I have a pair of aces and a pretty good low, but he could have like 5-3 or any low pair like that stuff. I think I'm going to save my time bank and just fold. I don't think that's too tight. I guess checking to him was bad. Maybe leading the turn would have been a little bit better there to keep him from betting a huge sizing like that. But given that I did check the turn, I think I have to fold to a pot size bet because we don't have a very good low. And he also has a lot of really good hands that could beat us, like two pairs and better aces sometimes. But flushes, straights, all this stuff beats us, and we could easily get into skipped in that situation. I'd rather preserve my chips and not get a tussle that early. I like our raise on the flop. I would have liked our bet on the turn a little bit more. And fold to a raise. Alright, so this is another good hand. Five-handed. I think this is how I'm just going to raise. If it was more people in the pot, I would probably... Actually, now that he open limps, I think limping behind is an okay choice. Given that we have three low cards and a decent flush, which does a lot better multi-way. There's really no reason for me to isolate and just play a bigger pot against Poker Daddy. We flop the nut low with a straight draw, backdoor flush draw. If it checks to us, we're definitely going to lead. And this guy bets. Okay, so we're just going to call. Hopefully one of these guys comes along so we have more chips in the pot to chop it through. Alright. So, that ace is actually a very good card for us, unless someone made a wheel. What makes wheels here? 2-4 and tie shelves. Golly. Yeah, I guess they just have straights too often, given the action. I don't see Poker Daddy and just like a flush draw. Even though we have a blocker to all straights with our 5 in our hand. And given that we have the second nut low, oh man, given all this action, I think we just have to fold. It's just a spot where I feel like I get quartered a lot. Also, our hand doesn't get any better on the river. Yeah, I mean, he had a straight. And he did as well. Unfortunate. Unfortunate, we had a good hand, but our fold was perfectly reasonable and good. Unlucky for us, we run out, but that's okay. Alright, so this guy has started back up. Ace-3-9-9, I think if I was later in position, I would play this hand. But not having a nut low potential is hindering this hand's strength. So we flop a decent low here. We just pair of fours in our hands, no diamonds, so no help in that department. Yeah, I mean, if they bet, we're just gonna have to fold. There's not too many good turns for us, or any good turns for us, now that I look at it. Maybe even a four would be bad. So given that, we're gonna fold. One of my definite edges in turbo tournaments is I can adjust really well to shorter stack play in PL8. Because I do have a background of playing sit and goes, which move up, and there's a lot of dynamics like changing table size and stack sizes, and I think I just have better experience adjusting versus all these players. So we actually would have flopped a nut low draw on this table. but nothing else really going for us. The pair of nines could very well be behind for the high. And the board pairing, now our pair of nines are even more of a dog, and we're just drawing to a low if we had played a marginal hand. So this is what I mean. If you play marginal hands like this, you're going to get stuck in weird spots that you didn't need to be, and if you just folded pretty a lot. Calm down, Mina. Mina wants to play. Chill out, girl. I already gave you the snack. You already got your snacks. Alright, so another red hand. We're just gonna fold it. See, this is what I mean. I late reg with 1,000 chips, and all of a sudden everyone stacks are really close to each other. I only have 1,000 chips beneath average stack. Actually, check the prize pool out. The prize pool, wow. Big prize pool. 435 for a 200 guarantee. There are 27 players left, 5k. So even if we make the final table, we might not cash. That is a huge cash. Huge cash. So let's cash this freaking tournament. That man.
Calm down, Mina. Okay.
I'll let you out on break, okay? Show up over my chat, maybe someone's trying to chat with me. Or maybe I'm just talking to myself. Which is okay. Queens. Pseudo queens. Have them or raise? I don't know. I'm gonna limp. It's okay, MPLA, when you're unsure and you just limp. Because so often you just get to see a free flop. Not this time. This guy's raising a small blind. I feel like he has a lot of aces and all that stuff. Can I call? Man, it's such a good price to call. Or can I preserve our stack? Given that there's so many people in the pot, and I have a high only hand, I should fold. Because I would be effectively competing for half the pot with very non-nutted, not enough potential hands. Yeah, I mean, like, that would be a trouble flop for us, because we have, like, top pair, with our pair of queens, but our hand doesn't get any better from there. And in all forms of Omaha, you definitely want a hand that gets better along later streets, or has the potential to. So, yeah, I mean, these guys had monster hands. So ace 3 makes the low, and a pair of aces is going to pick the pot. Wow, 3 nines. Good. Alright, so we have a suited ace over here with some decent low cards. They are connected, which helps, but they're kind of like the troubling ones. If we see a flop, we want to see like a 2 or a 3, 8, 9 would be okay. 8, 5 would be cool. We could flop the 8, 5 of diamonds would be very cool. Alright, we're going to limp it and see a flop probably. Okay, so we flop a 4-6 low with 2 pair. This is one of the spots that I was talking about leading. I think it puts a lot of pressure on like ace-king hands, even if someone has just like 2-3, and we pick up the pot there. Yeah, there's really no reason for us not to bet on the flop. I feel like if I check, it just gets checked through, and I see a lot of bad turns. And if someone actually had like a really good low draw hand, or not a Lothar thing, I guess it would have been made Lothar, probably would have called anyways, but I would have I would have been in a position where I could put a lot of pressure on them on later streaks with my two pair and my made low and my straight draw, so it's okay. There's a lot of worse hands I could call me too, like if you had like Ace-King, Ace-King XX, Ace-King low cards, something like that. Alright, so we've made a straight on this table. I'm definitely going to lead out into 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 people. I think it would be silly not to. He calls. So there are straights that beat us, but I don't think those straights would have just called here. Hopefully the board doesn't pair. Okay. So the 8 is actually a good card for us. Or, I don't know if it is a good card for us or not. We lose to ace deuce, ace 3 for the low. I think I'm going to check the side. Oh, this guy snap checks. High hands that beat us are going to be like, what, jack 9? 5, 9, anything with a 9, I guess, would beat us. People shouldn't have too many 9s in this game. I think I have to call this, given that he could just have a low. I don't like that this guy is also behind us, but it looked like he had his like check fold button on. Did he call us? Oh, we might get quartered. Oh no. Awesome. So they both had ace deuce. I guess I should have bet. That was kind of a tighter line, but I don't mind how he played it. I like our bet on the turn. I think betting the river just could be out of position. Could just get us in a lot of trouble. If someone like re-raised with like a nut high, and someone else calls behind. So if I had bet the river and it had gone like raise call, it would have been pretty hard to play, just because someone could have like the nut low, someone could have a better straight, or someone could have the same straight and I would be getting quartered because someone else has the nut low. So I like that our check call on the river there. I think it minimizes our losses, and we can still have half the pot locked up sometimes, but not enough to just like bet call. So our river play was just fine, in my opinion. Alright. We're rolling here. Not too much has happened, but we haven't made too many mistakes either. Or any. We're playing perfect poker. And that, my friends, is hard to beat. We pick up a good hand over here. A suited ace with pocket threes. And a king. Should I isolate versus this guy? Nah, we're pretty deep, and my hand is well multi-way. Especially if we flop the deuce of hearts. The deuce of hearts would be like the nut best card in the window for us. Because then we can make a nut low, and a heart helps us make the nut high. So deuce of hearts is a card we want to see on the flop. This guy raises, I wonder what we do. But they don't raise a big blind too often, so I'm not too worried. And if he raises his big blind, 13's gonna call, I'm gonna call, give him the odds. Ace can fall behind. I don't think Ace might be crazy and raise or anything like that. So, alright. Not the flop we wanted. We can try to steal this pot if it checks around. More than likely, it's going to end up check folding. We got it for cheap. Even if we see a heart on the turn, it'll be pretty hard to continue, given that it's four ways to flop. But if someone bets, we can talk about floating and bluffing them on later streets. Let's see. I'm so tempted to put up just a small bet here. Just something like, kind of set up like a bigger bluff on the turn. Maybe knock down the pot every once in a while. Alright! Pair of threes. I like that. That's a good result. And we are profiting this tournament. We're up 500 chips.
Not bad, you guys.
Ugh. Might as well just give me the last 10 of the deck. Just give me all 4. I'm gonna fold anyways. Might as well give me all 4. Just make it a cool story. Ooh. Set of aces versus a flush. Oh, it makes a boat. Oh, man. Unfortunate player, right? Alright, we got another playable hand here. We are going to open limp with the ace deuce. And the 4, which is cool. We're back up and everyone folds. Alright. No point in playing in his hand. It's just a check fold, do over 10s. I guess there we might win, but I doubt it. We do have a gut shot. We're half a pot now. We go. That is a good flop for us. If he checks to us, we're definitely going to lead out, given that we have a wheel draw, factor flush draw, and the nut. The unbreakable nut low. So let's apply some pressure. If they have ace deuce, they will call, but they're kind of free rolling us. Because our low is unbreakable. If they have something like 6-4, good luck to them. But we have the... Oh wow, this guy raised us. Interesting. Does he have a monster? Is that what he's trying to tell us? Tell him he have like 8. He might have flopped a straight. Hard to do that. We have the nut low. What are we going to do? Backdoor flush draws. Hopefully he doesn't have 5-6. That's not good. We're going to chop it up, more than likely. And that's what happens. Now that's kind of silly of this guy. I think if I was him, I would have called on that 13 coming to the pot. Because he's a big favorite to win the high. And if this guy comes along with second best, this is more chips for us chopping the river. Or chop after the river at showdown. But unfortunately, his plan was to raise it and blaze it with the nuts. Which I guess I would have. Check raises, not high. Alright. We're gonna call over here in position. I like seeing a flop that is pretty much a high only potential. We have A7, but that doesn't make it lows. So we flop top pair, top kicker. Can I bet into 3 people? Will they fold often enough? And if they call, we have to keep barreling. Given that we have a backup low, I think I am going to bet something like 100 chips. I don't think, and we would fold a check raise, obviously. Just too much equity, and we should protect our chip stack. We're looking for a jack. Pretty bad card. Could have made a flush. That's 60. Another 60 chip check. So we've made a low, and we have a pair of kings. That's I guess it's a pretty good bet for him, because if he turned to flush, then we're in trouble. We have a very bad low. We're losing to a lot of lows. I guess I wanted him to either bet small and I would call on the river, or just check and we'll see if our hand wins. But we lose so many highs, we lose so many lows, pretty, what is the right word? Pretty speculative call if I had made it there. And we're not going to make speculative calls. We're going to make good plays. We're going to make good reads. We're going to play good poker. This seems like a trap hand. We're just going to fold. In Omaha High, this would be very, very good to play, and I would definitely want to see a flop with it. But, given that there's so many low potential out there, I just can't play it. Yeah, I mean, that flop would have been a nightmare for us. even though we have, like, top pair and gut shots. Two low cards on the flop is never good for us. Okay. That has two pair. Pair good? No, that would not be too good. Yep. Can I keep flinting? I'm folding. Alright, so we flopped two pair over here. But not much else going on for us. Someone could have flopped and made low with their ace deuce, which is very common in this game. And they would bet it. And I have to fold, give him two more plays behind us, and it's hard for us to nut nuts. We want nut nut. We want nut high, nut low. That is what we want. Give us what we want, dealer. Give us what we want, dealer. $80 to win $720 with a really bad hand? Miracle's gonna happen. H34. Just in the window, please. This can't be a huge mistake. Oh man. $320 to win $140? The one wants $70? We're so deep stacked, this can't be that big of a mistake. I guess I'll call given the price, but I really don't want to see like a miracle flop. I don't even want to see diamonds. Okay. It's not a bad flop for us. I've been in this spot before and I haven't led, and I feel like I should definitely lead. Now, we are losing to a lot of better jacks, but we have a backup low draw. If this guy raised with ace deuce, he's going to be in trouble. A lot of ace deuce in the fold. And we have a lot of outs to make a full house. That's one of them. So let's just start piling in the money. And we win. Thank you for your chips. That's how you play a small blind poker right there. I'm gonna call, but I feel like this guy's gonna raise it. I feel like he's just gonna pot. Is he gonna tilt pot? He's so deep. Is he really gonna tilt pot me? Be nice, buddy. Come on, be nice. Be nice. Come on, 8. I got lucky, dude. Be nice. Be nice. I want to see a flop. Alright, alright, cool. Oh, and another good flop for us. So up here, you just have a pair of fives, 2-4 for the low, which is pretty good. But I might just fold. Call with our flush draw, backup low draw. Wow, props to 8 for not, rage. Oh, wow, we make the nuts again. Alright, let's put in some money here. If he bets, we were going to raise. If he checks, we're going to bet small. Small. 960. Smaller bet. It allows all the low draws to continue, and they're gonna have some bad news. Hopefully the board doesn't pair on the river though. This guy check raises us? Oh, hilarious. Oh yes! What a great river! What a perfect river! Oh man, what are you doing, buddy? We have the nuts. We have the nuts. We have the nuts. Alright, we're gonna win this one. good pickup there. We might be third out of 24, which is a good spot to be in. That was a good two hands of poker for us. Can't say the same for our on-demand, but we've only lost 500 chips. 995 deuce, pretty speculative. Folding it is the right choice. You know these blinds are going up so fast, but that's okay. We're gonna find, being short stacked, your high only equity hands go up. And your multi-way hands equity go down. So like ace, deuce, rag is like fold now. Just because so many people shove behind you, and then it goes like heads up, and you don't want to be heads up with just like a low drawing hand. Whereas if someone like lifts a low hand and you repot them with kings or aces or like queen, 10 jack or something like that, you're putting them under pressure with just a low draw, and they're playing only for half the pot, and you have an advantage for the top part. The thing to remember about PL8 is that high hands, there will always be a high hand, no matter what. There will only be a low hand 60% of the time. And I say only, there will be a low hand 60% of the time. And that's given that people qualify for it. So, in that situation, or given that truth, it's going to be correct for us to play to that. 10 big blinds. I have kings, 5 and a 3. I can raise it and blaze it. This hand is good for heads up. It is not good if all I have let everyone in behind me. He could have aces and have us crushed. He could just have ace deuce, which is okay, I guess. And he could just hold. Alright. Not a great flop for us, but we don't have any more chips. I'm gonna bet. He might call with just tens or jacks, queens, could all call. He might hold everything else. Okay, he probably just had like an ace deuce hand. 20 big blinds here. We have a high and a low hand. I think we're gonna raise it again and not fold to a shove from most people. Our hand is very strong. They have any pair. We have ace king, which does well against any pocket pair, except aces and kings, obviously. We do flop an ace. I think we're gonna check this flop. Let's see a cool turn. Not too many cool turns. This guy bets 500. Yeah, it's really hard for them to have a flush. I've been in the spot many times before, and I've seen people just like try to rep the flush out of position. Is this one of those times? Yeah, it is one of those times. Oh, yes, two pair though. Oh, no, two pair me, please, pair the board, kind of. Yeah. Alright, we gave him his chips back. Seems fair. I knew he didn't have a flush. It is fucking hard to flop a flush in this game. Give him 4 cards. We did have the queen 9 for the 2 pair. We had ace king. We were drawing to a king or an ace or a 3. He also had a backup low. But, care about that. Yeah. So, given the position he tried to put us in, I think it was time for us to call there with top pair, top kicker. We had how many outs? 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We had 7 outs 2 times. So 14%, so like 7 times 4, 28%. It's marginally close. Maybe a little bit worse given that he has a backup low. But yeah. Queens here. Hey, I shove it in, which is cool. Let's see a flop. We do a little stop and go. Closing the action. That's abysmal. It's just a terrible flop. There's so many aces in this game. People's hands. If someone has an ace, we're just so far behind. We would be drawing to another king, another queen. And get, like, wrecked by a spade. Ball? No. We're gonna play 7 big blind poker. Oh, wow! That would have been so good! Oh, I can't believe I folded to him in bet. But it was for, like, a big chunk of my stack. That's alright. We're gonna make up all the money in this tournament over here. On demand was not our baby today. I played 2 and lost both. Feels bad, man. 3 low cards, flush, and a pair. It goes in small blind. No, we can wait for a cooler hand. I've come back from worse. Oh, wow, look at this. Yeah, all these guys have real hands. Wow, all 4 aces. Do I have a 9? Upside down 9, and this guy scoops the pot. I'm glad the bet stack is out. I haven't marked it as being a good player. We're first in chips. 20,000. I know that 20,000 is a final table chip stack size. We have over 2x the average. Well, okay there. Pair of 61, not low draw. It's so rare to see aces on flops because no one is able to get the people's hands. We have a queen. Alright. 2 queens, 2 low cards. Raise it and blaze it. I don't want to wait. bust or win. That's my strategy. I gotta raise it up here. We call, we have queens. Alright, we gotta dodge a king. King spades. Oh, we had a dodge so much. We have made it low. Ooh, Queen of the Deuces, did we scoop it? No, we don't. Yeah. Okay, what happened here? What is happening here? Raise, we raise. We have a really good hand. Do I go with it? Yeah, this hand's too good to fold. This hand's too good to fold. Oh, we're behind. Oh my goodness, no. Oh wow, he woke up with a fucking monster. Oh. Oh my goodness. Ugh. So, that was a nightmare. I mean, we're gonna recuperate. We lost a lot of chips. Lost like half our stack. But we have a really good fucking hand. Man, ace, ace, deuce three? Is that just not the best hand you could get dealt? This guy was an idiot and he didn't have anything. Really. We're definitely in second place. Jeez, given this guy's exact hand, that's fucking terrible. All in here. They're all gonna call. There's no point in seeing a flop and folding. I wanna see all five cards. And I'm gonna wager all my chips that my hand will hold up to that pressure. Deuce on the flop would be great over here. Deuce of clubs on the flop. Deuce of clubs, five of clubs, please. Give me a straight flush draw. Oh, wow, he folded. Really? And another fold? Oh, man. Not great. We're gonna need some help. Low card, please. Man. No ace deuce, that's good. We have the best low draw. Oh, come on, low. No, we missed. Yeah. What was he doing? Alright, we bust out of this one. No good. I'm probably going to fire off in the limit tournament. Let's see here. What can we play? What can we play? Ooh. Alright. So this one, 15 minutes. Oh wait, this is Hold'em. No, I'm not playing Hold'em. Okay, so this guy starts at the top of the hour. This can be our next baby. I'm gonna keep playing two tables, and I guess I'll give both of them on screen. That way, I don't have to switch back and forth. Too much effort. I can just see two of them at the same time. Yeah, I think my shove in the on-demand tournament was fine. We had three low cards. It wasn't ace and deuce, which kind of hindered it, but we did have enough flush draw, which helped our high potential. And we did have the only, or we had the best low draw. Two. Ugh, that kind of sucked. Could I have avoided that? I mean, I had ace, deuce, king, queen. Queen. I mean, that's just a monstrous hand. It's so good. Could I have avoided this? Alright. Let's see the action again. Maybe I could have done something differently. Okay, so I raise, which is fine. We have very good high potential with three of the highest cards in the deck, and we have very good low potential with the ace deuce. This guy raises his small blind. Whenever that happens, I default to thinking that people are strong. Even given that fact, though, I mean, my hand is super, super strong. This guy shoves for a little bit less. So I guess in this spot, I didn't need to Jimmy Jam. I don't think I needed to jam there. I think I could have called, seen a flop, and lost a whole lot less chips because I would have folded this flop like 100% of the time. Yeah, I guess that's what I could have done. I didn't need to raise this guy and get in with him. That was kind of greedy. And it was a very strong hand, and it can't be that big of a mistake, given the range of hands that he can have. We're gonna put some pressure on here. on the big stack guy. I called his open bet, which means I have a lot of drawy hands, a lot of the clubs, a lot of just random ace deuces. So we made a pair of fives with an ace four for the low. We're gonna bet one more time, see if I can't shake him off like just a random jack. If he has ace deuce, he'll just call. If he raises us, we have to fold. Queens and fives now. We could easily scoop this pot. But I think he just check calls with deuce, the ace deuce. I could go for really, really thin value, right? I mean, he could call me with what? What would he call me with? Like jack eight exactly. Are there any low draws? I might just like flick it in. Like 2-3, which don't even beat. I'm just gonna check. Chop it up, buddy. Maybe I could have gotten cold just that low. Let's say it wasn't that low. But regardless, it's fine. It's fine. We're still gonna win this tournament. Minor setback. We got our sights on you, player 4. He seems pretty solid. I won't mark him just yet. He did wake up with aces, and that's the only reason I had all those chips. This one starts in 15 minutes. We have had luck in this tournament before. I think I made second in it a few times. This one I know I've come in second. I don't think I won it. I think I came in second twice. A lot of second place finishes. Makes money, but not as much as I would like.
Oh, I went out of straight. Went out of trouble straight. Oh, 6-7! 5-6-7-8-9! 4-5-6-7-8-9! With a low draw. Oh, I still limped it. I should have come along with the shiggles. Oh, and now it sucks. It's, better shot out there. Chill music. See if I can't get something more up. A little bit more. Oh, would I made another straight. How do I keep making so many straight? Not a good straight. Not a good straight nonetheless. And the boy pairs. Who's that?
He probably has it.
Oh man, and so many chips. I'm gonna run some math.
Alright, so looky here. I have some math for you guys. Oops, that's gone. Gosh dang it. Silly. Alright. So, given our hand. Oh, well, I didn't have to use a knife, I wasn't blocking my own notes. So, But given that, load is just gonna go up by like, oh wow, it's like gonna wobble. Okay, so this is our hand. This is versus 10% of hands, like the top 10% of hands. And this is the other random guy that just put his chips in. I give him 30%. Might be generous. This exact hand is probably like 30%. We have an edge over all these hands. 36%. We win the low a shit ton of the times. The most times. So let's change that to that guy's, like, crazy 3-betting range. If he has a 3-betting range in the small blind of 5%, maybe we're getting wrecked and we don't know it. No, still like a coin flip. So, yeah. Yeah, it wasn't a mistake getting it in, but I think it would have been more profitable in the long run to flop, play from there. Also, for stack preservation purposes, I think it would have been better to see a flop and just like fold. Because it was terrible. But yeah. It was a little bit of silly, a little bit ambitious to try to get all the chips, even though we have the highest equity. Still a little bit ambitious. We should have really deserved our big chip lead. But it's okay. We're gonna rebound. We're gonna win. We're gonna win! That's my plan. Good hand. Got the ace and the deuce and a flush draw. I get two deuces, which makes it harder for us to be quartered. Because I'm blocking out other ace deuces. I guess if it goes raise, raise, I'll fold. I can't fold a single raise. Given that I'm in the big blind, so I'm more than likely going to be priced in. If it gets raised, I don't close the action, but I doubt 8 is a limp raising, which is something that we don't see enough in these games. So I'm not worried about it one bit. I'm going to see a flop. Don't raise 4, be cool, man. Just call. Yes.
Okay.
Good flop for us. We have a low draw. I think if I was in 8th position, I would bet just in that low draw. But given that I don't want to build a huge pot and like just like work out the last few cards, I think it's better to just check call. If it does check around and the turn is something cool, like another spade. We have the nut spade, of the nut flush blocker. I think we're down to 18 people by the move over here. And that is a nut low. We have two pair with the deuce in our hands. That's bet. I think on the bigger side? Maybe, I'm just trying to get like an 8 to fold, random pocket pairs, like 10s, 9s. I'm not expecting like kings to fold, but maybe 7s and 5s. Alright. Alright, let's go. 2x starting stack. 5th place, 18 players remaining, 5 places to pay. Alright, so evaluating this hand, it is mediocre at best. 10-9 is okay for the high. The 10 kind of helps make Broadway every once in a while. The ace-3 gives us decent low potential, second low potential. We also have flush draw potential. It might be too tight to fold. I think I'm going to call play post flop. But, do I want to play a big pot? I mean, this guy, big huge. And there's a player behind. I think I'm going to take the safe route and just fold. I don't want to get in conflict with another big stack and just out of chips. So just hold this game. I think if I was in the big blind, I would have to call. seven more minutes to our LO8 tournament fires up. We're going to win that one as well. That's the plan. And after that, I'll probably stop playing for a while. I think I've played like two of the on-demand tournaments. This big $10 rebuy. And then the Turbo Zoom Sec. Limit high-low coming up. Would have been like a marginal spot for us, right? We got a flush draw, but we have a blocker draw, a flush draw. We have a low draw, but a marginal low best. With four more guys in the hand. So, this is why you fold these hands, to get yourself out of, keep yourself out of trouble. Ooh, I want to win this guy so bad. I want to win this tournament so bad. $174 up top. We're only in for 10? Ooh, I want to win this so bad. I want to win. I want to win. And just the min cash is so valuable. I think, oh man. Given the freaking payout structure, I should have followed that ace deuce pre-flop. Ace deuce king queen pre-flop. Because min cashing is 3x my buy-in, which is a lot of money. I mean, don't get me wrong, we still have a huge stack and we're still chipping up. I would just rather not have made that big pre-flop mistake, which I feel like is a mistake that a lot of people will make, and I don't want to be one of them. I think my hand is good enough to see post-flop. Okay, so I think I ran more math than that, actually. So given that this guy is shoving with, like, I don't know, any pair, right? I have a king in my hand, so it's kind of hard to have that, but whatever. Given that he like shoves Jack, I guess. Given that he like re-raises any pair. Come on, do the math for me. All the way up to 10. How we do. It's those hands. We're a favorite. But not that big of a favorite. Now, comparing this, or let's put 30% hand for the random guy. Because it was three ways, and that does change the math. Yeah. So, given that we're 37% to win that pot, and that we had a really, really good chance to min cash. Where is it? Given that with 20,000 big blinds, I mean, our chance of cashing this little tournament is like, I don't know, like almost 50% if not more, or 50% if not more, risking 25%. Cashing equity. I don't know if that even makes sense. It's just what I'm working on in my head right now. Would have been better. Would have been better to just fold. No, it wouldn't have been good to fold pre-flop. Would have been better to just call, see a flop. And then call, and if he re-raises, fold. But it's so hard when you have aces there, though, you know? So hard. I think I'm gonna limp his hands. I wonder how aggressive 13 was. He raised the last hand. Oh no. Short stack. Don't jam it in, buddy. You don't have aces of kings. I have your blocker. It was so fucking hard for him to have aces. because I have a man. Carving up with kings or queens. It was a man. But he woke up with it. Ace, ace, deuce, brick, brick, comedy. That's okay, we're gonna battle. I like my bubble play in the late tournaments, so I feel confident in my Guild 8 bubble play. Let's get to the final table and I'll worry about winning it there. I have bubbled before and I'll do it again, but that's not the plan. The plan is to win first place prize of $170, which is crazy. Crazy. This guy, what does this guy have? Like ace deuce. I mean, I kind of hope that one of these guys scoops it and this guy gets knocked down. But he probably has a pull. Which is probably hard to beat. Wow, okay, he has all the fours. He has every last four in the deck. 28. What was he in there with? What are you thinking, buddy? We're still very, very deep, so I have plenty of time to pick good spots. Man, I hate these flops when I flop top two. Flop top two, I mean, that's been the end of us. All the freaking big tournaments we've played. All the $30 tournaments, top two, wreck every time. Alright. Here's a limit one. Man, I think I fired off like what? $7 rip. Another $7 rip. $14 already. $10, that's $24. And another $7 right here. $7. So I'm firing off what's like 30 bucks this morning. But I'm gonna win one of these, and it's gonna make up for all that. So let's do that. In these Limit 08 tournaments, you play a lot of multi-way pots, just because, people can't really, like, repot and punish you and make you fold. People are more likely to call along if it's a mixed limit tournament. So our edge comes in picking good hands to, play multi-way. So our ace deuces, our ace threes, I mean, a very similar strategy to how I play, pot limit. I just feel like there's a few more. There will also be more raising, especially if I'm in position with a two-way hand. The goal here sometimes is to really, really save your big bets. So turn and river are the big decisions, like they are most games. But that's where your play needs to be the best. So we flop bad here. I don't think I can fold just yet, given that a lot of my two pairs are going to be good. Except jack. So now we can fold the six. There you go. First hand. Ooh, the ace birds are back. Can I 3-bet with this? Is it worth my tournament life? Is it gonna let both these idiots have me covered? Not. Wow, that's a pretty good bluff for us. We're gonna bet. $9.99. They have pocket jacks, we have outs of that with our ace. Ten's a bad card. We're gonna check it. Just a pocket troll. If he pops it, we're gonna have to call. He doesn't. Alright, so we've made quads. I think he calls us with a lot of pocket pairs because it's hard to fold a boat. I think he folds a lot of straights. Given that he's probably not going to call with the straight, I think I'm going to put a heavier size bet out here. Something like this. Okay, we win. I think checking will be abysmal because he just checks back all the time. 100% of the time. But hey, we got quads. That was cool. Let's make more quads. How about a straight flush? How about we make a straight flush? I'm gonna lead here? No? Yes? No? No, I think I'm gonna check raise. You have the nuts, buddy. Boom. I don't care what you had. Because I have you beat. He did have a set of aces. And we did river him, but we had a lot of outs. Could I have capped it? Nah. What's 40 more chips? It matters, but whatever. Alright, we got a heap over here, thanks to our quads. I wonder if he, like, turned a straight and then he just, like, folded. Folded on the river. Given that he lost, like, a lot. I could have bet smaller. But I like betting bigger. It really polarizes us. It's like either we have a 9 or a pocket pair. And if he has a pocket pair, he's going to call us. Like if he had kings, queens, any big pocket pair, like above, I don't know, 8s. What if he had pocket jacks? That would be cool. It'd be a cooler, actually. Alright, let's keep running good. That's my strategy for the next hour. After the break. We're gonna run good after the break. Should probably resize this one. We're on a 5-minute break, 14 remaining, 7 players at each table. Final table incoming. I'll be very sad if we don't make it. And I'm not going to be sad, because I'm going to win this tournament. That's what's going to happen. Sorry, everyone else. We're going to get in the money, and then we're going to win the whole thing. That's my general strategy in this tournament, is just to win them. So today's good low card, Jack. I could raise. I have a two-way hand, right? That also does one multi-way. That is also pretty easy to fold later. Make bigger. It has good hand. We're really looking for some low hearts. That's what we want on the flop. Two free hearts. Two free of hearts, please, dealer. Is that too much to ask for? Or maybe like King Queen. King Queen Rainbow. King Queen 10 Rainbow. So many Broadway possibilities, too. No middling cards, that would be the worst. I'll take no middling cards. Oh! King Queen! Ah! We have the best draw. We have a mini wrap. If we make a jack, an ace, or a 10, we have straight. We're gonna cap it. We have the best draw. With a backdoor flush draw as well. Oh wow, bet fold, interesting. We're gonna bet again, punish any low draws people might have. If anyone check raises us, we're just gonna call. But we're gonna keep putting money in this thing until we make a straight. Can we bluff? Can we just toss in 80 chips here? Just like. Do they ever fold to 80 chips? Oh no. Well, it was worth a shot. There's 1,000 chips in the middle. Yeah. Ooh, bad run out. But I think we can put that one fine. It was a big pot. If there was like a 10% chance that they folded, the bet was fine. Climbing back from that little hole. Fifth place. Pretty close up here. Not for long, because I'm going to win. Is this speculative? Yeah, it definitely is. But, we're short-handed here. Six players. It can't be that bad of a mistake. I would like to see an ace of the flop. Preferably the ace of diamonds. That's not it. Wheels got it there. I can improve to a better straight if I make a four, though. I have, like, the second nut low. Deuce 4 being the best. Check, I guess. Alright. Still hard for people to have a wheel. Call you. 4 would be the best card in the deck for us. That would be nut for us. How about 3 pair? How about I just click it in? Sorry, he probably hasn't yet. Man, it's such a good hand. But the big river bets aren't that big yet, so I think it's okay to make some speculative calls. It was very, very, very likely that he had a wheel there. You know? Just so likely. But I'll toss him 80 chips. Cool hand, bro. Oh, man, would have flopped another. Oh, look at that. Open. Not open. A straight flush draw. Please don't hit it. Oh, not a straight. Please don't hit it. Would have just. We still have a straight, though. Not. Yeah, they're not straight. Yeah, we're still gonna. It would have made a look. Oh, would have scooped the spot if it checks around. We would have scooped it so hard. Damn it. Yeah. Oh, that was ours. That was our pocket scoop. Alright, so I'm gonna change the playlist here. Libit. This is a great hand multi-way. Such a good low. Decent hybrid. Great, great flop. For us. The cool thing is, like, even if we make our, like, an ace would be just the dream card for us. But any low would be really, really good too. No point in raising, we're gonna call. We have like an unbreakable low draw. Deuce, two, three. An ace would be a great card for us. Not the ace of fuck. Ace of spades or ace of. What's the last one? Spades. Four is a bad card for us. Can we continue? Between a four, I mean, positive. I guess I fold now. Given that there's really no way for us to come high. Unfortunate, because we have such a good draw. And we make a low a huge chunk of the time here. Well, what if I call this guy like raises? Do I call off my entire chip? Tight fold. Good bet. I guess. Kind of silly of him to do that if he didn't have the four. And it's probably unlikely that he had the four. Whatever. We were only in like 1,000 after the flop, and it was a range. Alright, let's pop some clubs up here, or maybe an eight. Oh, clubs! With a low draw. We're gonna bet this. Plenty of good turn cards for us. A low card, club, an 8 would be cool for us. 9, because we have a straight draw. Not the 3. Can I rep 3? Do these guys just fold low cards? Let's say they don't have a 3 and like a low brick saw. Maybe I can bluff on that. Jeez, man. Ace deuce is good. Check and pray. Ace deuce. And a better hand. Oh, we're getting wrecked over here! Where are my clubs? What happened to the run good? There's so much run good, and now it's like just run bad. Horrible, horrible flop throws here. We're gonna keep battling, find good spots, take advantage of bad players. Wow, we had almost identical hands. Small blind. The average stack is well over 20 big blinds. Is that right? Yeah, 20 blinds is like 8,000. So we got a long ways to go, guys.
before we get to the final table. Backdoor flush draw, backdoor low draw, three will give us a nut low draw. Away. Okay, I have to see that one. Can I bluff this? I think so. I think I have to try if it checks to it. Probably like tank and bet. Maybe like snap bet. Call too often. I don't know, like, it might call it just spades. Hey! We bluffed you!
Pew pew!
Another good hand. Raise it. Come on, deuce of diamonds! Oh my goodness. I guess you have a good hand. Still, if you want to raise out of position, you should rarely do this. Alright, no one cap it, please. Keep it cheap. Oh, yeah, there's a deuce of diamonds. Alright. Going in, everybody. Four diamonds now. Four diamonds. Six. Okay. So we've made the second nut low with a pair of three with a flush draw. We are going nowhere. Oh, wow. Trip threes now. I call you one last time. Aces. No good. Five, he gets quartered? Maybe? Oh, we get quartered! He made it straight in the river and didn't bet it. Alright. Silly. Yeah, buddy, I know the board paired. But you're in position, one guy just called. Me. Yeah, his raise is reasonable. He did have ye ol' aces. Ah, so much more comfortable with two pair in this limit game, the pot limits. I'm still gonna check it. Try to make a boat. No backdoor low draw for me. Oh, kind of. Right? I have a 3-7, but it doesn't make any good loads.
make a boat.
Let's check it, is it? I gotta keep betting and have a flush. Yes! Step into the web of lies. Oh, we made a boat when we raised it. Hope it's not pocket 10. Welcome to the web. Welcome to the web. Are you re-raises? What do? Just check all? Oh my gosh, you telling me you have it, dude? You have pocket 10s! Bet call a raise. Oh, I don't have pocket 10s! Oh, shit! Oh, that's way better than pocket 10. Oh, no. I had to bet the river, right? In case he had a flush that wasn't folding and was trying to bluff me. I didn't want to just, like, check behind. We could have saved a big bet there. But we're still really, really deep, so it can't be a huge mistake. And we have a really, really, really strong hand, too. That guy, betting his sets like a champ, though. Alright, we're gonna bet here. I don't know why. We have an 84 low, and we win the pot. Uncontested with ace high. Ugh! I get a pocket king. That's all four kings in the deck, just out there in the open. The question is, could he have done that with just like trip fours? Maybe he wouldn't have raised, given that there's a flush out there. Is there a worse boat? Or did I just have the worst boat? I think I have the worst boat. Yes. Yeah, I mean, he could have had 10-4, right? He could have had 10-4, and I thought I was silly. Yikes. Not a great rotation, but that's alright. We're gonna have to start playing a little bit more lockdown poker. In the limit one. In the pot limit version. We are battling. We're battling hard. This is a 3-card hand, I'm gonna fold it. The bane of Omaha players' existences is playing 3-card hands. The game allows for 4 cards, and if you throw away one, just have a crappy one. No good, shame on you. Big Pop Parker over here in the sky folds. it's our friend number 8 who we got our big sack from at the beginning. Alright. Alright, alright, alright. Alright, we've made 2 pair. Top and bottom pair. I feel this happens more often to me than it should. We also have a straight draw, so I can't fold if someone pots it. It's all potted. They're saying they have ace deuce and they plop the wheel. And would you pot it if you had ace deuce? Because wouldn't you want people to call you? Because then you have nut nut. We can't fold yet. I have to call. Yeah, the board needs a pair or I make a deuce. Okay. I guess I can check raise him. It's something small like 1,000. Let him call with like just trip fives. But we're gonna try to something most. Oh wow, he was bluffing! He bluffed! He had nothing! He didn't have a high or a low. Maybe he had a shitty low and was like, I pull. Because if he doesn't have the wheel, he has to feel like he's in trouble. Don't I have the wheel if I just check all 1,000? I don't know. Cool! Thanks for the chips! Thanks for the chips, buddy! Well, I bet the river. Maybe he'll just like call it behind with like a really, really bad low. He was just bluffing. I was kind of scared that he might have pocket kings, but I guess he didn't know. Alright, suited ace. 30 big, 35 big blind, or I don't know, not big bet. Do you count this one in big bets or big blinds? I think big blinds, because then you can calculate how many hands you have to find a good hand. Another call raise here. So once again, we're looking for the deuce and the three of diamonds. So it's very specific. I'll take a deuce or a three if it's not of the diamond variety. But I have three low cards in a limit game that's going to go multi-way with the ace high flush draw. Folding would not be good. Alright, so this hand, however, is, do I raise or fold to shove? Hey,
buddy!
You're gonna limp here, getting everything else left. This guy raises and something weird happens. Alright, not a great flop. We flop top pair, but not really much else to go with it. Bet again, we have a good low. Ace 5 low, we made it straight. Bet one more time. We got it, buddy. Ordered! Alright. Ooh, bet the ace? I just fold. I can't play against you guys, you're too good. We want 14 to win. Want him to vacuum all of the money up, knock a few players out. That would be the ideal situation for us. Wonder what he has. Did he flop like a made low? Spicy. So, yeah. Interesting. Bad result there for our tournament proceedings. This is what I'm talking about earlier with a 20k stack. I mean, maybe I should just fucking sat around and chilled. I had 21k, and 21k is plenty to make just like cruise into the money. So yeah, that is a little bit of a mistake. There was like no chance in hell that that guy folded after he 3-bet to my raise. Well, I'm still stuck in that hand. I know. And I know that we're still chipping up, but we could have played it better.
And that's all I want
to go on about. Tough. Ah, would have made another straight. This sounds like video game music. Ooh, what a terrible straight I would have made. We can limp it again. This is a good hand to open limp with. I call a number of raises. Top it up. I'm just gonna chill. Someone knock 26 out, please. Ideally, one of the bigger stacks. We don't want stack size to be flat. We want us to be the leaders and everyone else. But yeah, this is one tournament I do not want a bubble because the bubble is so big. Alright, pair of sevens, backdoor flush draw, backdoor straight draw. I bet? No, I think check calling is better. I don't want to bet in my call or raise. Seems like it could be a bad situation. I know we have a suited ace and three low cards, but they don't make good lows. I block my own flush out, and ace-10 makes not very many good hands. Alright, I think I bet out here. I have the nut. Flush draw with a good low draw. Anyone with this, I could like scoop up the pot if someone has a straight and like a low spade comes out. I don't think a 7 would be a good card for us in the river, honestly. Really, I just want a low card, like the deuce of spades would be the best. Maybe this gives me some equity as far as bluffs go on later streets. And the ace comes in, which is okay. It's okay. I have 2 pair, and I think it's a schoolboy hand. I think I have to bet. The only lows to beat us is 2-3. And we have 2 pair, do we scoop it? I guess 2-3, we're gonna chop it up. That's right. He also had two pair, but my two pair was better. It was a good river for us. Or, I don't know, an okay river for us. Yeah, actually, good river, so we could have chopped it. No loss otherwise. So we got a flush draw. Got shot to Broadway. The king. But no low potential with four players behind us. 16 cards. Hard to play against, hard to bet. They're gonna check. I think I have to call one bet. I can still make the nuts. I need a red king. King of hearts, king of diamonds. 9. Also good card for us. We'll go for a check raise. I can't fathom, it's like... Okay, so we definitely have the nuts. Last I checked. So we're gonna put money in. Hopefully the river is a brickety brick brick brick. That is a brickety brick brick brick. We are gonna bet one more time and win at least half the pot. Call 14. Maybe I could have went for the double check raise. Would that have been too ambitious? Alright. What does this guy tell me? He probably has a worse straight. I'm gonna raise it. Maybe 10 will fold a low. Yes. I wonder if calling would be better so that 10 comes in with, like, obviously a worse hand than what us two have. So many good high cards. I want to check on my, where's my break? No break. Oh, break already happened. Would have two pair here. Might be good. Would be good. Just had 8 and 2, so we can lose that. There are 11 players remaining over here in this contest. Oh man, such a marginal hand. I do have possession on a few players. Type fold. Stack preservation, I don't want to get into War 14 and have to like call a big portion of my stack. Although that would have been a great flop for our low draw potential. Alright. Let's see some hearts dealer. Hearts. 2 or 3 of hearts. I feel like I've been calling for 2 or 3 a lot because I've had ace 4 a bunch. Maybe some Broadway cards would be cool as well. Or maybe 2 pair. Top and bottom pair, 2 pair again. Oh my goodness. You're not making life easy for me. Alright. I hope the turn becomes like another 4, give me a full house. I might even be ahead if it checks around. I mean, I think I'm ahead most times in this flop. I think I bet if it checks to us. Did I raise? Can I even raise this guy? Yeah, I mean, how do I not have the best hand here? I lose to 9-6, which I'm blocking. I lose to pocket 4, which I'm blocking. I lose to pocket 6, which I'm not blocking. And no one raised with pocket 6s. Is it better to place the pot here in position? I might be saving like a big bet on the turn. No, we're just going to make full house. We're only losing to pocket 9s, which seems hard for them to have. They might call us with just a low draw or a flush draw. But I gotta keep betting. I mean, I'm repping strength, and there's no reason to stop repping strength. And I don't want them to get a free river. It's hard to fathom that any of these guys have pocket nines or pocket sixes. Only because no one re-raised on the flop. Like, his hands would have re-raised and kind of punished low draw. Unless they're very, very sneaky, which I don't know. Ugh. Bad luck for us. The low draw got there. And this guy called. I think I'm going to pop it one more time. He could have pocket eights, but I don't see that being a rowdy too much of the time. We're going to raise one more time. Oh my goodness. Maybe he made a straight. Do I get quartered? Am I about to get quartered? What am I losing to? I'm not. What if he has 8-4? I'm gonna be greedy. I mean, this might be crazy. Come on. Yes! 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 Great bet! These guys are gonna chop off the low hand. It's bad for him to raise there. With the low. Because he has to think that maybe he's gonna be getting quartered. And it allows me to get wrecked. I was getting berated. I'm not gonna say anything. I wanna encourage Ten to make mistakes, but I normally don't talk in the chat and I'm not gonna start now. 14's anger at Ten for re-raising. You should have folded, Muppet. Oh, the drama. Oh, the drama. Did I chime in? I just chime in with a smiley face. They're just gonna be pissing on each other, and I'm sitting there like, nuts. Smiley things! Okay. We got a really good hand here. I don't like raising. Okay, we missed. This is why I don't like raising. You just miss flops sometimes. It's just a reality. I'm gonna fold. Yeah. Great fold. I'm drawing. Did. Wow, these guys are going to war. Alright, he takes down the pot. Go to full house. Wow, so kind of you to show, sir. Thank you. Alright, so 19 is on the chopping block. We are one away from the final table bubble. Too tight? No, it can't be too tight. I think it's rare that you can be too tight in Hollow Middle Maha, though. Just saying. Just saying! Another bad hand. Oh my goodness, I'm still kicking myself over that 20k loss. We would just be chip leader. Just donated those chips. Oh man, how can he have pocket eights of them? Still in my head. He's still in my head. How can he have pocket aces? I have one in my hand. Oh, so bad luck. So bad luck. Eight suited. No good low potential. I feel like this is a trap hand. I mean, even in limit where it can't be that big of a mistake, I just feel like it's a trap hand off and stuff. I'm just gonna fold it, preserve my snack size, which is a big one. I have 5th out of 32 people. Not bad, in my opinion. Alright, 8 scoops up a big pot. That is good for our chances. We are like 3rd in chips at this table. Maybe I'll rail the other table. Look at this. Look at this, though. $174 up top for a $10 buy-in. I've only been playing for like 2 hours. Alright, so everyone over here has, at the other table, has a bigger stack. Or has, like, over 10k. Over here on the side, I'll pull it up if something fun happens. It is the bubble of the final table. I would rather make the final table than not. What's up here? Would have made it a low draw with a flush draw. Both of them are bad. And then we would have made a pair. With an 84 left. Which is terrible. Alright. We're gonna keep folding. What these guys failed to see is that, there's still plenty of big blinds in circulation. There's no need for us to get you out of line.
Calm down, buddy. I think I know it.
Let me win this tournament, and we'll go to the park. Or lose, and we can go earlier. But I would rather win. What if the music is too loud? My mic is picking it up. Gotta be okay.
No one's watching anyways, so whatever.
Alright. Ooh, can we fold this? Two flush draw? No, let's find an ace on the blob dealer. Ace on the blob dealer for a full house. Or just flop me a full house. I am losing to nothing. I have the nuts. Got the nuts. I got the nuts. If he calls, I'm gonna raise. I'll let these guys trip over themselves with their legs. Can I call and be sneaky? Is that allowed? I can probably check raise on the turn. I am kind of risking someone making a better full house. That's a really good card for us. We're losing to aces, but a lot of people made lows. Do I raise now? No. If we're going for half the pot, I want as many idiots in as possible. Another really good card for us, we also have a low. We're gonna just bet out. We lose a pocket sevens, pocket eights, and pocket twos. Scoopa? His low is slightly better. Yeah. I like the way I played the turn. I'm glad I called to allow these two guys to burn off 500 more chips. Well, now we're second in chips. That is good for us. But we want more. We want more chips. That's okay. We have almost double starting stack. Oh, this guy's all in. Let's watch. Let's watch him. Oh, we would have had the nuts. We would have had the nuts for this bad man. Oh, he gets quartered. Oh, we would have gotten wrecked if we were in there. Why did I fold that hand again? Was I not paying attention? What happened? In the small blind? Did I just make a tight fold or did I go raise? Nah, I don't like that. No, no, no. Yeah, this is like an auto click. I don't like this. A lot of low cards, but the nut flush draw and no wheel potential. I don't like folding there. Ugh, I think if I was playing 1-2 more, I would have called and seen it. Maybe I would have gotten. Maybe I would have not gotten to the river. I don't like that fold. Uh-oh. We have an almost all-in situation over here. Oh, no. Cool. So 13 is on the chopping block. As well as 19, who has a plus. Yeah, we're gonna rail this one. Watch for this guy to get knocked out. Uh-oh, we got an all-in. We got a call! Overcall? Overcall? Overcall, uh-oh. Alright, Big Pot Poker on both the tables. This could be the final. This could be the final table, guys. This could be it. Uh-oh. So much action. Alright, who's out? Who's in? He's out! He's out! Final table. Alright. Oh, we get dealt a decent hand. Can I raise it? And all these big stacks. Ah, that's a lot of clue. We're gonna pretend. We're gonna tell him a story of us having nothing, and now we've got the moon bet. We might call us with just a low draw, and we win the pot. Okay. Sure, queens will help our cause. This is what I mean. We're at the final table. Well, I guess a 20k stack wasn't enough to just cash out right, but still, would have been more than 15. Alright, someone go Busto. We're three away from the money in a very, very, very big, big, big bubble. 3x buy-in bubble. We want the moolah. I'm not gonna fold this. Looks too tight. Three wheel cards, nut flush draw, in position. It's just too good to fold. The nine kind of hurts our hand kind of, but it is a club. It doesn't make nut flushes, which is good enough. In most games. Terrible flop. Can I pretend? I don't want to pretend. People check raise with like trips too often. And then I just like what bet fold. Seems silly. And I can check find a deuce. Check find a deuce on the turn. That is my plan. Deuce! 7. Alright. It's kind of a trap card for us. Oh no. Hoping 8 would scoop up the pot for someone else. What do I do with this hand? We're gonna open limit. Two wheel cards, 10 high flush draw, and an ace high flush draw. Alright, and then fold the rest. I didn't even need to isolate. And we flop. Very good. I think we flop too much to even bet. Do we call? Or raise? Just call. Alright. Hopefully they don't have King 10. But we do beat all the flushes. We do beat all the trip tens. We don't have a nut low anymore. I'm gonna bet something like this. I want worse flushes to call, and I want trips to call with their boat potentials. And they both fold. Alright, they were just messing with us. They were just messing. Suited ace, but not very much low potential. And I think my chip preservation is going to be good here. Oh, I would have flopped okay over here. With our not really. Alright, so 915 now, please. Come on, 4, call him. Call him. Hello, D-Lap. Good to see you, buddy. Good to see you. Yeah, I'm playing pretty good. Running pretty decent. We got quad nines earlier. That was cool. I had like 21k at one point, and then I lost half that, and I've been building it up ever since. So. Ooh, look at this. Big Pot Poker time. would have been whatever. Any pair is good here. Go with it. Go with it. Uh-oh. Pause. Here's a flush draw. No hearts, please. Chop? No. No chop. Sweet. Alright. Seven players remaining. Two from the bubble. Big, big bubble. Let me show you the payouts, Mr. D-Lap. Maybe I can have both of them. See if that's possible. Is that a frame? Yep, that's a frame. So, fifth place will win us $34.80. We're in for $5 first buy-in and a $5 add-on. So we're in for $10.50. So winning $34 would be a very, very good return on investment. Just for a min cash. Valuable, valuable min cash. You get a fold here. Not much going on. You have a gut shot, spade blocker, and a pair of eights. Not enough to continue out of position against someone who has less cover. You're about to see some gruesome bubble play. PL8 bubbles are freaking brutal because it's so hard for people to get knocked out. Aces, 3-2 over here. I think raising is cool. No reason to slow play this hand. Not in limit where everyone just call. Uh-oh. We could see some bust outs over here, guys. We could see some bust outs. Which would be just fine with me. Bottom on the left is it's a $7 tournament. Let me see if I can't pull that structure up somewhere for you. What happened? Oh, we would have made a boat! The fullest of houses would have knocked half the tournament out. Gross. I would have never gotten to the river. But hey. Ugh. Call. You flop a flush? That seems hard. Okay, maybe we can fold in the king now. Pair of aces. Any two pair beats us, straight got there, he could have flopped a flush. Bet into us twice. He's telling us that he doesn't care what we have, it seems like. I don't think I can or should call this one. Alright, buddy, you can have it. You beat my aces. Hold him. I would have hung in there. Did he say he bluffed me? Did he show me a bluff? Alright, you get attacked for that, asshole. You get attacked for that, butt face. Alright, player 8. Alright, we see you. Bluffed us. We get a yellow tag. Seems silly to bluff. Just saying. I could have had the flush, I could have had the straight. You were just being silly and clicking buttons. Now I actually have the flush. Don't see not betting it. Gonna bet again. We have low draw here. And now we've made a low and the queen high flush. And he folds! What did he call us with? I couldn't call the river. Wow. Seems bad. Alright, two from the bubble in our $10 tournament. 14, please exit, hand your chips over to player 8, and get out of here. Get out. 24 is rumbling. Alright, 14 has a pot size bet left. It doesn't look like a flop that he connects with most of the time. Lariat bets out. It might go fold. I would not be surprised to see 14 get in there with just a low draw. Fold it is. Alright, so he's going to get the life squeezed out of him. And then we would be next on the chopping block. But there's 20 big blinds, plenty of room for me to maneuver. I'm going to call this one. I wonder if Aegis is going to raise with any 4 cards right now. He shouldn't out of position. That's a good flop for us. Hopefully though, no one has Ace-King. Or spades. Do I check into it? Checking too tight? I thought I did that hand right. Okay, so I know I have the best hand, probably. But I could be doing a variety of hands, right? I could have just two low cards, 2 spades. He might contain me just 2 spades. The queen is an okay card. If he had ace queen, he would be ahead anyways. So we're gonna bet one more time. Set up for a river shove if that's what needs to happen. The king. That's a bad card. Check and pray, I guess. We have blockers to a straight. I don't think I can go for very thin value here. Would he really- wait a second. Would he really check raise me? With a straight that I block? Let's go! Great bet! Perfect bet. Thin slice. Thin value. Let's go. We're in good position now. I'm glad I bet that. Glad I bet that. And I'm glad I bet the size that I bet. Okay, so he did have a worse ace. I think he would fold if I potted it. Right? Because that would make him more inclined to fold with this terrible, terrible kicker right here. The only ace that would be ours is like ace 10. Or sorry, ace jack. And that was the only hand that could beat us, given that he checked the river. Because I don't think he would slow play any full houses, given that I have like a pot test bet left. So I think he was in check call mode with a marginal hand. So that worked out really well for us. I'm going to replay the hand. It was so sexy. What do you think of that one, D-Lap? Played it great, yeah. Thought I potted it. Value. We have the best hand, we bet one more time. Now, I bet kind of small on the turn to let him continue with, like, just low draws, just flush draws. It could have been a little bit bigger. And then I go for another small bet on the river, and he does call. Again, if I knew he's had exactly the ace, maybe I could have bet slightly bigger, but I wanted to almost look like it was so small that he was priced it. Maybe he would call with some pocket pair sometimes, I doubt it. He can only call with an ace. My bet sizing could have been a little bit better, but that's okay. Played it great. Played it great. That is a thin slice of value. Probably not as thin as I am and making it out to be. Given that he was only calls with an ace. Would have been an okay flop for us right there. Come on, 8, knock him out. Get him out of here. Yes. Oh, he has a queen. Hold it. Oh, yes. Alright, we're on the bubble. The bubble. I get 3x my buy-in just for cashing this little baby. Just for cashing! How cool is that? I just wait till one of these idiots gets knocked out, and then I make $20. Start off the day. Not a bad way to start off the day. But I want more than just 30 bucks. I want 174. That's my plan. But first step is to make it into the money. Alright, we're currently third place in chips. Looks like this is going to be a big pot. Looks like it could potentially be chopped. Looks like that might happen. Yeah, chop it up. Sad day. We didn't like the chop. Again, 20 big blinds deep, which is a lot of big blinds. I would equate it to like 40 big blinds. You never really get in like shove fold territory because it's really hard to shove. And seeing flops is very, very equitable. Even with 10 big blinds. So yeah. You're really not in like shove fold until you get to like 5 big blinds. And then you would just find like a good high equity hand and you shove it in, or a good low equity hand and you shove it in. Two main hands, obviously, you would shove it in. But yeah, there's a lot of maneuverability, and I think I have an edge in that department because I play a lot of sit and go, so I understand the bubble scenarios a lot better. I also understand the short stack ranges a little bit better, so shorthand PL8. I do pretty good in, and that was actually one of the games that I used to play a lot of cash games in. So even deep stack six-handed PL8, I'm comfortable in. Basically, we would have turned the not nutter butters, but situational nuts, right? How could someone have 10 king? I guess it's possible. All right, come on, 8, you can do it. No low. 1.4k in the middle. That's a lot of chips. A lot of cheddar. Oh, if he checks, we would have the nuts. Sad day. Is this guy gonna win it with 2 pair? Yes, he is. Oh, we would have won that one. Alright, we're gonna win it. Hello, Mark. Shout out to my main man, Mark. Always watching me on these Saturday mornings. Ooh, we pick up a good hand over here. We have 3 wheel cards. The ace deuce, which is beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. I think I'm going to raise it. Put pressure on these guys. If I was earlier in position, I would call. And call a raise. But given that I can play this hand in position, I'm gonna raise it. Alright, hold this one. Player 4, player 9 is short, and player 9 limits it. Oh, this guy just bet one more time? Okay, we're gonna call. We're gonna call, see a cool flop, and then go with it from there. Hopefully we'll flop some low cards. Him raising, he could have a majority of hands. Let's see what happens. Ooh, big pot over here, he's got some pots of bet left. Hopefully 8 knocks him out, and we're in the money. Checks it. Check again. No low draw. Only a high hand will qualify. I would have had 2 pair. 2 bad pairs. Not a bad one for us. We have a pair. He has 2,000 left. I guess we're getting in the middle. Volume. Okay. Now we're guaranteed. Pretty low. And I'm gonna bet again. We could easily scoop him. I fold over there. Oh wow, he just folds! How bad was his hand? You have 1 big bet left. Or 1.5 big bets left. Okay, I know I folded over here, it's kinda tight. But given the bubble scenario, I mean I'm just not looking to see a lot of flops. With somewhat marginal hands. So yeah, I think folding this one might seem tight, but on the bubble, I think it's okay. I really want to preserve my stack and make sure I get in the money. Especially with player 8 in position, he can apply a lot of play pressure. So let's like think that if I limp this one and 8 like pots it, which he could very well do. He has the most chips at the table, and puts a lot of pressure on my limp, and I just didn't want to be in that situation, so I'm just gonna fold that hand. And don't get me wrong, early in the tournament I would have definitely limped it, and maybe raised above later position. Okay. We're gonna have to bet here. We have top pair. We have the best hand the majority of the time. Alright, 2 is a bad card for us. What do I do if he bets out? Interesting. This could be a bluff. Could be a bluff. He could also bet a deuce if he thinks that we check back too often. We do beat any 2 pair, right? We beat his jack 5s now. But we're like rushed if he has a deuce. Also, if he has a low draw, we're even further behind. So, I think this might be a fold. If I risk 4,000 here and I lose the hand, I'll be sitting at 16, which isn't terrible, but I think keeping the chip here is fine. Given that we're still going to have more chips than 9 and 4. And 22, I guess. I don't know. I think it's a good spot for him to bluff. But, given that I can win a bunch of money by just folding, I think it's fine. Alright, we're gonna fold this one, especially number 4 raises. Hopefully these two guys cannibalize each other. Oh wow, that's gonna be a big pot poker. And I have no part of it. Would have thought a cool super duper wrap. Look at this wrap. How many outs did I have? To the high. Not even to the nut high, because it could be like a heart. But how many outs did I have? Uh-oh, and the board pairs. Alright, this could be it, guys. This could be it. There's no chopping, more than likely. Alright, no low card. Please, dealer! Yes! Okay, he has 3,000 left. Oh, I guess I would have preferred number 22 to win. But that's A-okay. Always love when someone is freaking crippled. Now, Ace-Deuce 310 is a very, very, very good hand. We are going to limpets. I don't see these guys raising too often. Maybe actually I should raise. To put these guys under pressure, under some bubble pressure. Yeah, I think that would have been the better play, considering I have so much low insurance. Player 6 should play pretty tight. If he raises me, am I going to be sad? Okay, so we flop top pair, nut low draw. We're going to bet. I know we're on the bubble, but I can't fold, right? Not yet. You need more reasons to fold, buddy. Okay, oh, that's a good reason to fold now. It's supposed to be a scare card for him as well, and I'm definitely going to bet this card. Right, I can get into fold a lot of 2 pairs, a lot of hands that have equity against a single pair, and I have low. If he check raises us, I mean, I guess I just fucking fold. Yes, let's go. Don't mess with me. Try to pick my stack size, player 6. You think like, because you have all those chips, you can just do what you want? I'm sorry, buddy. You can't. Oh, we would have the nut low over here, but we folded because we were under the gun. All right, back to lockdown poker. Back into the turtle shell. Make the cash and then win the tournament. That is a goal. That is what I want to do. Also, another secret of this high value tournament is that a typical $10 buy-in would have a $1 rake. Oh, more on that later. This guy's all in. We want a call. The two biggest stacks. Come on, flick it in there. Flick it in there, 8. Flick it in there. It's like a big line and change. Flick it in there, buddy. Come on.
Don't be a nit. Don't be a nit.
Don't be a nit. You have 60,000 chips. It's like 2% of your stack, if that. Alright, we're looking. I don't even know. I think they chopped the pot, honestly. Yeah. That's okay. Oh, we want a break.
We're on a break.
Alright. Shout out to Daniel and Mark railing this final table with me. Sorry I couldn't get to the final table last night in our $30 buy-in, but I'll make it up by winning this one. Can I fold this? Alright, given that this guy has a yellow tag, and given this is our big blind, given that we're given like 4 to 1, I call. We have some draws, we have some wheel draws. I guess I can call and fold to any high card on the turn. Yeah, I mean, we have to fold. I don't have a pair, I just have a low draw. It's just kind of sad. I can draw like a Miracle Deuce on the river. Just scoop it. I just don't have any pairs. So can I save? Can I save one big bet? Saving big bets are the name of the game in Limit. I think that separates the good players from the bad players. If we had one more club in our hand, we would obviously call and be happy about it. Good hand. Just saying, I know some of you guys like to show your hands afterwards, just like flash it. Anytime I see people do that, you're on my shit list. I just assume that you're a bad player. Whether it's true or not, I assume you're a bad player. This is kind of a suspect hand to limp along. I was in a similar situation yesterday in the Pot Limit Omaha game. That, having kings in the small blind or the big blind is just so suspect, especially without anything else to back it up. I'm in check call mode now. I don't think an ace would check the flop too often. Maybe they do and then bet turn. Like that. So I have a gut shot. I have a gut shot to the queen. If he has a 3, I'm buried. If he has an ace, I'm pretty much buried to my only out, which is like king or queen. I could have the best hand, but I doubt it. Would he really bluff and do 3 people each with 4 cards each? He's kind of brave. How many outs do I have? I have 4 queens on the deck. 1, 2, 3, 4. 2 kings. 5, 6. 6 outs. 12%. I don't think you have 12%. It's not even 12, like, clean. It's not even like 6 clean outs, right? Like I might be drawing only to the 2 kings if he has a full house already. I don't know. Seems kind of suspect. Seems close. But we're going to preserve our big bets. Maybe I could have taken control of the pot by betting, but I was out of position, right? I was first act. We had a flush over here. Little one. Set. One half. Yeah. If he folds, I think I'm gonna raise. Fold to a 3-bet. That's a really good hand. We have like a semi-nuttish flush draw. I'm not just gonna min-raise, I wanna make it look like I got thought about and that I have a really good hand. Queens and fours, hey? Yeah. Oh wow. Ooh, this could be trouble. What a nightmare if one of them busts out with 22 does. Or like if number 4 busts out with 22 does. What a nightmare that would be. Oh, Nate was messing with us. Out of position. Good to know that he's capable of that. Just bluffing a paired board out of position. I think I'll note that. All in. Rooting for the eights. Hold eights. No 10, no hearts. Ay-ya! Ugh. Heart on the river. Brutal. Brutal. Uh-oh, he's all in. Okay, come on, 8. Knock him out. Come on, buddy. He's been bluffing a lot. He might have nothing here. Pocket 8s. Oh, man. I'm really looking. Would they chop it? Yeah, they chop it. Chop up my big one. That did. That did. Alright, 22 survived that round. And profited, which is sad. We wanted to see him leave. But that is not what happened. So the two short stacks are going to go at it. We're rooting for player 9. But really, either way, well, someone's going to get crippled after this pot, more than likely. You going to fold 9? Oh, look at that. 22 is surging back. He's not dead. He's clawing his way back into this turn. Late registration has closed for our little tournament over here. It has closed. Which is just fine with me. Like I said, PLA bubbles are freaking brutal. Because in Hold'em, you can just have like 2 cards, you shove it in, it's normally fine. In this one, you can have 4 cards. But then you have to shove it after the flop, because typically, you know, it's hard to go all in unless you have like 3 big blinds, pre-flop. And then, half the time, you chop the pot up. So, yeah, these things are brutal. Oh, 22 makes his comeback. Player 9 is in the chopping block. Kind of sucks for us. If he hadn't rivered that freaking heart, bubble would be over. And then I can start opening up my ring. As it stands, we're going to chill and fold. We can fold, like, 4 rotations. That one. Alright, Clary, what you gonna do? Come on, chip leader, make a decision. Well, as he should. Would have flopped. Open and a straight draw plus a low draw, but it's not good. Not gonna flop. The 10? We are ninth place in the turbo limit, Omaha High Low. Oh wow, big pot poker over here. There is a low out there, so there's a potential that someone could they could have. Oh, Clary gets slapped on the wrist again. We've lost out of position a lot. We're gonna note that. I'm gonna give him a yellow tag. I'm just gonna assume that he doesn't have that much knowledge of positional betting and all that. Alright, me versus a short stack versus this guy who made a cool comeback. I'm not gonna bet, is it? Just gonna limp. You can see a flop. Don't raise me. I didn't raise you. Come on, dude. Be cool. Be cool. These two kids going at it again. I think this is a good spot to put in a little bluff. Or check. Or bluff. Or check. Or bet once. Fold. Check. Maybe we find an ace on the turn. Now I have fold. We have ace high after all. He survives his big blinds. Enjoy your blind, sir. This one. Love this turbo tournament. 28 players left, 50 entrants. $350 in the prize pool. 10 big blinds left. Look at this. We only played this in like an hour and we're almost at the final table. Seven handed. Alright, it would suck the bubble. 9 is coming along. That'd be cool if 4 raised. Actually, I don't know. I think it's fine if 4 limps. It goes 4 ways with the 2 shorties in there. Would have been a full flop for us. Open and straight draw with a 9. Back up low draw. But lockdown poker is lockdown poker. And it wins. I wonder if 8 is going to bluff again. Small bet. Could be a bluff. Oh. Alright. Alright, we pick up the birds over here. We got the ace and the ace. Should I call a raise? Call a raise, call a raise. If this guy calls, I'm going to raise him. Because he bluffed us, and I'm upset about that. We have the aces, we have a low card, and a flush draw. This pot is not going to get limp in, but you can disguise it. He calls. Uh-oh. Alright, so that's a pretty good flop for us. If he has a king, it's going to go with it. Oh, triple threes. Alright, and we scoop it over here. Wow, 8 continues to lose big pots versus them before. Goodbye to your outstanding chip lead, sir. And we are at 13k now. Very good position. This is an awful hand. 7-8 is not the low draw you want. I think Ford's a good player. Yeah, he hasn't really been afraid of the big stack. If it falls to us, I'm gonna raise this guy and get him with kings. If he raises, I guess I fold my king. Yeah. Yeah. Goodbye, king. Uh-oh, we got a caller. This could be for the tournament. Oh my goodness, we would've flopped all the kings. Alright, alright, alright. It's okay, it's okay. Keep calm, keep calm. Damn it. No, no.
Too tight.
Oh my goodness, this is so bad. Oh no! Well, at least the chips went the right way. King's in the small blind. Now you get queens in this one. Oh my gosh. Oh man. If we lose this tournament, that's the hand that I'm gonna remember.
When we bubble this thing, that's gonna be the turning point.
The sad turning point.
14 from small blind to a min raise.
I'm running away from this pain. Good news is 4 is very active, very aggressive, so I feel like he's gonna have a few all in competition with point 2. Oh man, we would have skipped that pot. Oh, that's tilting. Tilting! Alright, 9's all in. Bust him out, 8. You're crazy. Looking for a queen. I think he's dead. Chop it up. Okay, good result. I chop up the small blind. Not a big deal. Fold 8s. Oh, those kings. Alright. Cast it from my mind. Play the poker that I can play. Tilt proof, guys. We are tilt proof. Kind of. I'm walking. I guess we can flick in 500 chips and see if we knock this guy out. Funny thing though, guys, as soon as this bubble burst, I'm going to start wrecking shop. You going with it, 22? Is this it? Is this your swan song? Is it the end of the line? Nope, hope it's a big line. Which is good. Goodness! Ah, so frustrating. Fucking. Turn the old boat. Triple fives over here. This guy has a few thousand chips left. Where the sun shining down on my face. I'm running away. I'm bluffing. I am being a bully. I have nothing. Uh-oh. You're done, son. The fullest of houses. Kings are no good. Oh, good job.
Oh no!
He made the low. What happened? Oh, they chop up the low. Yeah. Yep, they got quartered. Lucky low. What happened over here? 22 picked up a 5. Oh, kings again. Oh my god.
Keep folding kings, just keep folding kings.
Oh my gosh, please have an ace or queen, dude. He has nothing. Alright, they're inching closer. We can't knock him down. Those kings, the kings! The turning point! Oh, the bubble would have been real. It would have been over. We would have picked up so many chips.
But no! No, we just folded it.
Just threw them away because it was a raise and we were out of position and... Ugh. Built. Alright, so number 9's in the pot here over here. 6 hasn't played a hand in a while. What are you made of? 8's better, good ass if you should normally bet that one, I feel. Well, it looks like we would have had ourselves trip 7s again. With the low. What One of these days, guys, I'm going to get to the point where I stop recording on the video. That's alright, we didn't get here by playing marginal hands, we got here by playing good hands. And playing those hands better than everyone else. That's how we win. Uh-oh, this could be it. This could be it. I wonder if Ain't just tagged along, because that's how he do. Root for 22 if he calls. Root for 8 if he calls. Root for everyone but 9. Screw you, 9. Get out of here. Your time's over. You can't have aces. I have an ace. Oh, he has a better hand. What's happening? He has a 7 now. Oh, he quarters this guy. That was the worst result. Oh, yeah. The grind's real, D-Lap. This is a brutal grind. And then, the funny thing is, after the bubble's over, the term is gonna last like 20 more minutes. I like that 22 keeps calling and stuff. I feel like he's gonna bust out. He's being kind of loose with his limbs. You should tighten that shit up, buddy. Or not, just get it all in against the big stacks. Come on, 8, knock him out. Yes, 4 calls too. Uh-oh. Alright. Come on, 8, come on, 4. Be my hero. Be my hero. No way, 2, like, 22, like, limps with aces, right? This is kind of a bad one for him. I feel like he limped with, like, 4 low cards. One of which could be a deuce, so he's counterfeited. That's a good card. No low. Please, no low. No low, because that way they don't chop it up. I'm probably going to make it straight on the river, just saying. Yep. I could have ended this thing. This could have been over. Aces! Please, please no two pair. Oh my gosh, another terrible result. Oh, is this going to happen? Ah. Oh. Oh. Lockdown poker sucks. Oh, we can get punished for it. Oh, 8 with the aces and couldn't get the freaking job done. It's okay, I like that these two big old stacks are next to this guy, and just like, he's never gonna get a free, get a walk. Like, never. So, 22 is under the most pressure out of everyone at the table right now. He's gonna need a lot of double ups to get back. Or maybe just one. Okay, come on, 4. Come on. Here's some kings! Let's go! No low, please. High. Yes! Quads! Yes! In the money! Oh, and we get kings! Okay, this is a great hand. We'll probably get walked because there's like a dead blind up there. Look at this. In the money. 5 players remaining. I'm not gonna fold kings. Kings and 9. What if he has a 9? Alright, so this guy has been pretty lucky. I'm gonna call. Bet this one. Check it again. Let him bluff one more time. I can check raise. The pan's off with him. If he has a 9, we're doing fine with our flush draw. If he doesn't have a 9, he's dead to our kings. We're gonna shove it in. He's been bluffing enough and he folds often enough. No 9, just a low draw. Full house! Kings! We chip up! Whack him and we take over his position. 3rd in chips. Kings full is good. Things are turning around. These kings are gonna win it for us, guys. Is this a king? Is this a king? I don't know. Is that backwards? I can't tell. Wait, it is backwards. Yes? King here? I can't do it. I'm so stupid right now. Is this here? Is it 1? King? No, that's definitely backwards. I know nothing. You get a walk, player 9. Okay, so everything is backwards. So it's this thing, and I don't know, it's like this. Are these kings? Yes. It's a cake. You can tell, right? Alright, we get a double good hand over here. Flop a low, not a good low, not much high going on. We have a pair of 10. Low, heck off. If I fold, can I ladder? No, I'm in position. Basically. That's a bad card for us. see that coming. And we're gonna need a fold. Why do we need a fold? Big bet, buddy. This guy's putting us in the cage, huh? Pretty bad flop for us. How can it be that good of a flop for him? Unless he has exactly ace king, ace queen, ace ace. He could have a low and just put pressure on us. We're gonna fold, you got it, buddy. He hasn't gotten too out of line. Three clubs over here in the small blind. Call. Hopefully no one raises it. That's what really stupid. Alright, bad flop. 9,000 chips, 18 players remaining, so we're down to the last two tables. 9 places pay, so final table will pay. Raise it up with our ace, deuce, 6, 3, double suited. Board over here. Come on, 8, you wanna rumble? Ooh, that's a good flop, bud. We're gonna check. And there's the flush. Hopefully he doesn't have a straight flush. Player 8, guys. Player 8. Player 8. He used to have 60,000, he kept bluffing it all off. That's why you get the yellow tag, right? Yellow because you suck. He's gonna be out of position and just like, I don't, maybe I have a flush. Nobody, you do not. I do. I guess I didn't need a pot, but I felt like he's so bad that he might call anyway. Flush. He's gonna bust it for a 9, isn't he? 9 is gonna do the happy dance because 8 sucks and it's gonna get stacked. 4, 9. Get the boot. Alright, there's a low out there. Might be a chop pot. Hopefully not. Hopefully 4 just like hand player 8 the finishing blow. I mean, he really kind of like self-destructed, right? Ah, the jump. That's fine. Oh, no. Alright, if he folds, we're getting in with this guy over here. We have a double suited hand, a low potential, high potential. We're going to get it in, be happy about it. Yeah, we have a better hand than that. Pair of sixes, he didn't make a pair of jacks. Oh, man, he has stripped jacks, we're dead. Yikes! Oh, wait, we won! With a flush! That's why you play those double suited hands, guys. Yeah, D-Lib. Eight is pretty horrible. I can't believe he bet out of position without the flush and just folded. He had like no plans if I raised him. He's like punting it. He is punting. Alright, we can't call this. Oh man, that flush and river, that guy was probably so tilted. He had all the jacks and then we just river the flush on him. We're in a good position for another final table. This could be a double final table Saturday morning, which will make this like every Saturday, like make it like a tradition. I just every Saturday morning, I make final tables. It's a good tradition. I would love to keep that tradition alive. Huh. Okay, so I understand that raising goes down in value when there are short stacks behind you. Because you really don't want to call re-raise and stuff like that. Does this guy win? Oh, he makes... Alright! We ladder up. 4 players remaining. We got 52 locked up in the bank. 4-handed. This looks like a walk. Alright. Good flop for us. We flop the nut flush draw. With a really good low draw. With a pair of 10s. He raises. We check raise. Get it in. No folding to be done here. If he has just ace deuce, he's going to call us. 7's bad. He might have a 7. And we make a straight with a pretty good low. Hopefully he doesn't have ace deuce. And he does. Chop it up. Alright, seems fair. Seems fair. Alright, so we are the shorty at this table. Shorty with the most skills, though, I would imagine. 6 is really tight. 8 is loose, aggressive, bad. Loose aggressive, so he's a bad lag. I would say 4 is probably our best opponent. Our strongest opponent. He hasn't really... made too many silly plays in my eyes. He's played pretty solid poker so far, and he's picked up on good spots to win the pot uncontested. So much respect for player 4's game. This is a bad hand. I think if that 4 is a little bit higher, I might go to call. Like, if it was a 8, I'd call. Ooh, walk the aces. Sorry, buddy. Three to raise over here, double two to aces. We are running pretty good today. Alright, I will limp this hand. It does well multi-way. And once again, we got some deep stack final table poker going on here. All that, buddy. I'm not scared. You got the ace two shield and you're out of position. I have positioned you with ace two. That's an okay flop for us. I wish I'd made a pair. That'd be cool. If he pots, do I fold? Can't fold. I can't fold. Let's find some low cards. I have a really, really, really good chance to make low cards. Oh, I got walked over there with aces, by the way. Alright, low card, please. Yes, let's make a straight. 3-5! Chop it up. That's fine. Alright, we're ahead of player 8 because he keeps making loose calls. Player 8, you're silly. Ugh, player 4, I knew he would put pressure on us. I feel like if I keep folding, player 8's gonna go out. Won't be long before he goes out. We got $52 locked up. Pretty good, we're only in for 10. Some of these guys might be in for way more than 10. Cause it's a rebuy re-entry, so if they bust it out, in the first few minutes they could rebuy and, you know, again, but I'm only in for 10, so I might have the most ROI right now. I'm gonna fold this one. Fold to the chip leader. Over here. Alright, back in the main game. It's getting closer. Six is still being a nitty Nancy. Dude has probably played like two hands since we got to the final table. And we registered the latest too. I mean, these guys have been grinding it out. Your number is the number that you registered the tournament in. So I registered this tournament 20 in 20th place. Out of 30 people. So yeah, I was one of the latest registrations. And that goes to show you why this tournament is so valuable. I can like register so late and still be super deep in chips after the break is over. Ace deuce. Actually, I will raise this one. Six folds a lot. If he calls, we're just gonna assume he has a decent hand. This guy three bets us, I guess we can get it in with him. We do have some high potential with the 10 and the 7. Not a lot. This board kinda sucks. But I'm gonna bet 8,000 and see if he folds a lot of hands. Golly, he got us. Oh, this is why you don't bluff good players. Now he tank and fold. Oh, why did I bet so big? He snapped it. He like snap raised. Ayah, alright, we got our hand stuck in the cookie jar. Ayah. Come on, four, respect the positional bet. I bet so big. I knew he was a good player and I went for a player that normally only works on beginners. So that's a little bit of a mistake there. That's okay, we're gonna cover and we're gonna win. Still pretty deep. Oh, this guy limped. We're gonna see a pot with this guy. Been so long. We'll flop two pair. Gut shot. Double better, I think. Ace three over here, this guy's all in. I think we're gonna call and limp along. If this guy raises, we call. Oh, this guy's all in as well. Can I call? No, probably shouldn't call. Wow. King's deck. Alright, I'm the shorty. Man. That will be our undoing. That queen 8-4, I just couldn't resist bluffing at it. But against a good player, which is kind of silly. Didn't need to lose that pot. Did not need to lose that pot. Alright, so we're down about 7 big blinds, which is a good amount. It's not bad. So my range is going to open up to include a lot of high-only hands like this one. I don't know. I think if it was a little bit better, I might raise it and blaze it. Ace's been raising a lot of good hands lately. I don't know if he's been gear shifting or he always raises a good hand. Can we go with this? Or can we call? Let's see a flop. It's fine. Alright, no more limping. We are getting punished. Not gonna lie, we're kind of getting outplayed at this final table. Kind of getting outplayed at this final table so far. Four-handed at least. We just made that bad bluff, and I think that kind of hurts us. But that's okay. Honestly, I should have picked up how these guys were playing and know that the limp a hand ago wouldn't have worked. And I also should have known that my little raise there didn't make any sense to this guy either. So he could have easily bluffed us out of that hand. Or demi-bluffed us, I guess you could say. Seems silly. I thought it would work some of the time. And honestly, I haven't really gotten like out of line too much. So I think he should have respected it. Damn right, D-Left. It was loose. Suit of King, sixth place. We're all in. I don't love it. He could have spades, he could have two pair, all that stuff. I do have a backdoor low draw. Backdoor flush draw, he could just have a pair and call. He could just have nothing and fold. That'd be cool. Alright! Said I would raise his hand. High only hands are good. They're a lot stronger than they used to be. Do we get in with this guy if he repops us? Seems like a bad flop, but we did flop top pair. I can shove here sometimes. This. We could just have a low draw and miss. Has kings. Oh, trip nines. Hold it. Hold the baby. Let's go. Cracking kings. We are second place in chips. All right. We have the ace three over here. We flop a gut shot straight draw with a pair of aces with a good low draw. I'm going to bet it against these shorties. Double final table, please. Which one do I focus on if we get to that? I don't know when. Just tell me, dealer. Shit. Oh, okay. So the board ran out to where I got countered for my two pair, and he had a better kicker, I guess. That kind of sucks. But that's all right. We still have plenty of chips in our limit game. Goodbye, player eight. Thank you for the chips. He's probably tilted at his kings didn't work. I wonder if he's chatting. If he's saying anything? Nah, no one's saying anything. That's all right. Ace, deuce, suited. Can I fold to a raise? How far are we from the bubble? I guess I fold this, considering that they both have a lot of chips. Just respecting it. And the bubble is important. I really need to win that last hand. How are we doing? We're doing okay against his hand. So an 8. Okay. So this guy raises. We're gonna have to call kings and sixes. I'm not gonna bluff a paired board again. This guy keeps whacking me. 8 might bluff at it. Decides not to. So I just have kings and sixes. I lose to a 7. I think if it checks around, I might win at least half the pot, if not scoop it. I'm gonna call this bet. Yeah. Oh, this guy's all in. Let's see, who's his ace? All right. Oh, he gets some fun. Queen, queen, queen! Come on. One less queen, please, dealer. All right, we have a high and a low. He's betting 5,000. I think I'm getting the right odds to call for half the pot. He could be just bluffing. He needs, like, what? Ace 3, 4. I mean, I'm losing to a lot of lows. But I don't think he has too many highs. I think it's just, like, a bluff for him. Nope. He has a pair and a better low. Or high, whatever. That's okay. We still got 40,000 chips. And he was giving us a good price to call. So I'm just going to call and hope one of my hands hold up. That's okay. We're coming back. We're going to win. The next ladder is going to be for $69.60. Right now we're at 52 left up. Okay, we have 8s and 3s. With a backdoor low draw and a backdoor flush draw, we might be getting it in here. Especially against Lucy Goosey 8. What do we do if he raises? That's it for you, buddy. Yeah. Wow, that's an awful fold. That's a terrible fold from that guy. His hand was not that far behind mine, like, at all. All of his two pair outs were live. I wonder if they can show you what. Does it show the flash? You know what? Fuck it. I should focus up. I should focus up. Oh, we get walked. We get walked. Okay, we're on the bubble of the final table. No. Two way from the money. We're 10th, 9 places pay. I have to limp his hand. I can't fold his hand. It's too valuable for the high. Too valuable for the low. Ideally, I want to see, like, I don't know, the deuce of spades. Alright, so 8 is not having an easy go. Like we thought he would. And this is why I'm so good at tagging people. I give a yellow tag, means you suck. Guess what? Player 8 sucks. Kings again. Can I raise and blaze it? No. I've gotten burned so many times for raising kings out of the small blind. This is a good flop. We're gonna bet it. We have a low draw and top pair, and it's so good. There's so many chips out there too. I'm not sure if I should be betting this flop or not. This guy folds. I'm gonna raise and get in with him. I have the kings and the low draw. King. We get kings and twos. Oh no, he scoops us. What did he have? What did he have? We were definitely ahead of the flop. How could we not be ahead of the flop there? Yeah. My hand was so disguised and everything. So, oh, okay, so he had two pair. He had two pair, it was a better hand. That's really bad. Now it's like kind of a flat contest between us three, which I don't feel uncomfortable playing in. Wow. Okay. Oh, wow. Someone's about to get busted out. I can almost guarantee you. Such a loose call. Yeah, I can guarantee you that player 6 was not bluffing, and player 8 chips are swinging back and forth through the edge of the boom. So he flopped 2 pair with the 5-3 low draw, and I had the 4-6 low draw. So yeah, he kind of had us crushed. But given that we had top pair and a low low draw, I think it was fine. We would have needed to river a king to scoop. Or king to win half. But oh, he didn't. Yeah, because he turned the one. Actually, king or six. So yeah, I had some outs, but I wasn't in great position to win that pot. Oh wow, we got clean. gold. So we're on the bubble now. Man, I've been paying so little attention to my limit one. All of a sudden, I'm like almost at the final table. Yeah, we're hand for hand. I'll stick this guy over here. We can sweat everyone else's hands, I guess. I don't know if you can see that or not. I'll bring attention to it if something's there. Alright, these guys are contesting for a pot again. Big pot at that. I think this helps the big blind's range that raised. He has a lot more ace deuces than this guy does. Forgive that he checked it. I wonder if he has just the ace deuce and not much high equity. Would have made triple nines again. Would have had the situational nuts. I doubt anyone has jacks or kings. Come on, player four, you got him. I would have had him. Ooh! Ha ha! Ah, player eight got caught bluffing again. Caught with a pair of kings! Yeah, I would have won that pot, but I don't play bad hands. I play good hands. Player eight. Not a great day for you, sir. Uh-oh. Re-raise. Respect it. Player four, you may take the remainder of his chips. That's a good hand. Oh my gosh, you flopped all the queens. Hello, chop it up. Chop it up. Ace deuce, chop it up. You can't catch a break. He can't catch a break because he sucks. Alright. So, 32 is being a silly billy on this table. There's no reason for you to tank. It's hand for hand. We're not playing anything. And, your tanking is stupid. Sorry, buddy. I'm going to tag his big blind. We're on the bubble. He's very, very tight. If he calls, we have a lot of equity. Boom! Give me your big blind. Second in chips. We're coming for you, player four. Can I raise it and blaze over this one? I think so. We got a low draw, we got suits, we got a pair. Player eight is bad. So yeah, I think that's plenty of reasons to bet. Come on, it's fine, I'll call. Get in, it's fine. That is not a good flop. Top 10 worst flops. If he checks, we can check. Hey, yeah. What are you doing over here? I'm gonna tank and fold, I guess. This guy raises it. We have ace four, queen seven. He doesn't have a lot of chips left. I'll call, see a flop. Off a flop. We're just gonna check fold now. Golly! Oh, so many chips! Oh man, I should have folded pre flop. This was suspect. Anyways. That was a mistake. I shouldn't have called it bad. I mean, I had a reasonable hand. If I flopped a, you know, ace queen, low cards, I would have went with it. Ooh. Jeez, so many chips. Oh my goodness, I'm gonna be a little bit upset if I bubbled that limit tournament. I would like not to. Seems unlikely. 32 is almost all in. Oh, he's all in. Rooting for the queens. Chop it up. Brutal. It's hard to knock people out when you have to split pot too. Oh no. Are we the tournament shorty now? No. 31 is the tournament shorty. We can fold into his big blind. I think it's better to fold, right? I had two big blinds left. It's about the same range. I don't know. It's close. If I call, we raise me. He has a lot of chips. It can't be that bad. It's probably that bad. Alright, rolling. Oh my gosh, we're gonna bubble this thing. We're gonna bubble. We're gonna fucking bubble. Oh no, we have a straight! Alright. We're not gonna bubble. We're gonna win this one too. We're gonna win the limit. We're gonna win the limit turbo as well. We're not gonna bubble. We're gonna win. You know who's gonna bubble though? That guy that has 5,000 chips. You're gonna bubble. I'm gonna vote for him to bubble. I should really be focusing on this table because there's a lot more money at stake. Alright. We got the 8th bird. Raids and Blaze, I'm not gonna fold. If I lose with aces, so be it. But this hand's too good to fold. Player H2 leaves me into just limp, he calls. Don't call, dude. Just fold. Just fold. How often do I pot pre-flop? Well, hope he doesn't have a 10. Yeah, I guess he doesn't have a 10. I guess he would have got in already. No 10. Okay. Yeah. He's dead to an extra king. He's out! We knocked him out! Get out of here, player 8! You're bad and you deserve to lose. Alright, so we have $69 locked up. It's about a $30 bubble for $104 for second place. That's where we are at. And we want 6 to get knocked out, and that's going to help because we've plopped a full house. The fullest of houses. There's no houses that are fuller than ours. I'm going to check. I want a big card on the turn. Oh, that's bad. Now we have potential to chop it. But I'm going to start betting. Seems silly not to. Pocket 8 beats us. And I also make a low. Ooh. That was fortunate for us. Wow. He rivered a bigger boat. This is why you have that low, man. That low one saves you sometimes. Oh, would have had a 3 kind of me. Bad hand, even 3-handed. So, is player 31 dead yet? Yeah, he won't survive this next rotation. Oh, we got aces. We got aces! Hmm. I'm gonna see a flop. If he raises, we're gonna get it in. Fine. 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 You picking our big blind, buddy? He didn't snap call, that's good. Alright, we got aces. Hold against his ace too. Oh, no heart, we're dead. Oh, shit. Oh, but we made a low! Ay-yah, we bust. Blind versus blind! I have aces! It's the right call. We don't have any low equity, but he could easily be doing this with, like, kings, and if he has just a low draw. Oh, and look at this. I think we're at the final table over here. Oh, final table, 9 players remaining, I think. And we're on a 5-minute break. But we do bust this one. Let me see, could I do anything differently? No, he raised our small blind, and I know that ace, ace, queen, 8 is a very, very good hand. He made the 6 low, right? His 6 beats our 8, unfortunately. I'll run the math on that. I know I'm ahead pre-flop. I know I'm ahead on the turn. I know I'm definitely a dog on the river, unless 6 peels. So to win, to chop that one up, to river a 6. Did not happen. We bust the tournament. Still pick up some good loot. Yeah. My hand was too good to fold. Spades, ace of clubs, but I will run the math just for fun. Versus ace of hearts. Ace of hearts. I like that he didn't snap call. Spades, and I'm gonna unroll it as well. Clubs. 9 hearts. 2 spades. I don't think that's much argument for me always wanting to see a flop there. Let's see. What did I type in wrong? Club, spade, heart, spade. Heart. 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 Clubs. And hearts. Spades. Alright, so this is the unroll thing. Unroll just means that we're checking it out pre-flop, post-flop, pre-flop, flop, turn. Okay. Alright, so it looks like I'm a dog. I'm a dog on the turn. It's basically a coin flip. I could arguably see a flop, but aces are so strong. Shorthanded in Omaha, especially when it's suited and especially when you have a backup low, right? And he raised us, so he could easily have stuff like King-King XX, King-King 2-3, just a bunch of low cards, which I have a really good equity against. He did have a, I would say, like a 30-40% hand, but we had him, not crush, but we definitely had equity over him pre-flop. Flop comes, really shitty flop for us. We did not want to see that flop. We wanted to see no low cards at all. Like, zero low cards, zero hearts. We also had a heart blocker, the eight of hearts, which kind of sucks. But he ends up flopping the flush draw anyways. And he has low draw. Did he flop a queen? No. And a straight draw. Right, a five would give him a straight, and that's really bad for us. And we're dead on the turn. When he makes a heart, we're dead on the turn. Doesn't matter what the river is, we're dead. I don't know. I was trying to push my equity advantage pre-flop. Now I can run this with a range of hands that he could have raised his small blind with. King-King, Queen-Queen XX, Ace-Deuce XX, Ace-3 XX even. Maybe, like, yeah. I think these are reasonable hands that he would bet. And maybe every once in a while, just like a random 4-card hand. The 4-card hand seems kind of suspect. I think he would be raising small blind pretty well. Okay, so against all these hands that could raise us, against that range of hands, it's fine. Yep, against any ace deuce XX hand, we're doing great. I mean, we have them crushed, right, with our aces. And let's put in some percentages, like 10%. If he's only raising us in the small blind with just 10%, we're doing great. Even 5%. Like, if he's only doing this with, like, super, super nutty hands, we're still ahead. So, against his exact hand, we have an edge. Against any range he could have, we're ahead. In the big blind as well. So, I think I'm going to make that play 9 out of 10 times. I'm also in position too, so maybe I could have, like, seen the flop because I was in position. But regardless, I think I played that one just fine. Alright, so since we didn't win that one, let's win this limit one. Alright, who are our shorties? 31 is our shorty, he's in the small blind. 33 got hit with a big blind, and this big blind hurts his stack big time. The chip leader is 44 with 88k. Payouts are here. I have like 12 bucks locked up. Top prize is $105, a little bit less than my other turns. That's alright. That is okay. Alright, so let's win this one. Can I make this screen better, I guess? Let's make this table bigger. Oh, we got an all in. Are we gonna ladder? Are we climbing the ladder? Nope. Chop. Alright. One table. Alright. Guaranteed $12 just for making it to the final table. Alright, I think we got it all in somewhere. Nope, chop it up. Alright, queens. Honestly, I don't know what to do with this in this spot. We have two low cards, which is cool. Versus a rate. Can I wait? Can I wait? What's the ladder? Ladder for $2? Can I wait? Can we wait? Seems freaking close. Such close. He calls, we're gonna fold. Yeah, I mean, that would have been and this guy could easily get it in, and I could ladder. Alright, that's a good card. We're looking for no low cards so they don't chop it up. No low. Chop it up. That's okay. Alright, we're gonna hold this hand as well. We'll wait around. The limits are so freaking high that I would bet good money that a few people get knocked out before the big blind gets back to us. This is a very fast tournament. We're in for $7.70, so $12 locked up. It's a little bit of a profit there. If he's gonna raise, I'm gonna fold. Yep. Seems good. Alright, no more low cards, dealer. Low cards always come when you don't want them to. Like that. And they're probably gonna chop this one up as well. I'd imagine. Or not. 39 is thinking about it. Oh wow. Cool. Yeah, it's fine if he pulled. I go with his hand. So what hands do I go with if I don't get hit by the big blind? It's gonna be four low cards. I think is okay. And any pocket pair bigger than maybe just aces or kings. Maybe like queen if I have stuff to go with it. Like queen 2-3 I can go with. I think that is fine. I don't know. How long have we been streaming? We've been streaming for 3 hours? Oh my gosh. This is the longest stream ever. But you got to see the beginning of the turn all the way to the end. All the way to my final table bust out, which is unfortunate. We got out in third for a good sum of money. Got out in third for this many. $9. Putting in $10 is pretty good. But I wanted this. Oh! Ooh. Such a big gap, look how big of a gap that is, $70. Pretty sure player 4 did win, yeah, player 4 won. He was the guy that I had marked as the best player at the table besides me. Unfortunate. Is that a base in here? Big pot. No low card in the river, please. Ooh. There are going to be some chop pots. Hopefully 31 gets none of it. Hopefully 39 gets none of it. Oh wow, it's a two-way all-in. This could be a cool ladder. And it could be like a four-way chop, which would be sad. That's a good chopping hand. You might even scoop it. Ooh, it's deep. Chop it up. Three-way chop. Man. Okay, so we can actually survive a blind. This guy would get hit with a blind before we do. Oh, and the raise. Oh, and a shove. Okay. And another shove. Come on, 44. Hot odds, buddy. Yeah, get in there. Check. Seems good. And the bets. He's gonna take the blind. Oh, is that the nut straight? Is that Broadway? Alright, we're gonna lose 39. We're gonna move up one rung in the ladder. 33 has one big blind left. I think we're better off waiting. $1.35. This seems close. I could raise it and blaze it. I feel like these two could get in and bust very often, and I don't think this guy is ever pulled a fire. It would have to be an all or nothing. Maybe I can do it with these two instead of these two. I don't know. Seems close. All in? Alright, that's fine. We're going to call it if we should.
tip leader. Gamer shenanigans. Oh. All right.
Looks dicey for somebody.
Would have made a low and top pair, top picker. And we would only lose to a wheel
or a straight at this point. I just bet. There's not much in the soft pot you can test for. They're really going for the main pot. I like the 10 bet because maybe he has a good hand and 31's going to bust out and move up the ladder. Which would be nice. Nice and public.
Might be shutting the door, but I doubt it. This looks like a chop pot most of the time. The good news is, maybe someone has a wheel and a 31 gets wrecked. Oh, not the wheel. Oh, he won. Oh no, what did he win with? What did 31 have? 31... an all-in?
What is this shit? Oh my gosh! Just a jack? Oh, jack two. Okay.
So yeah, two pair. That's fine. Again, all in wager from 33. He's putting his life on the line here, as I will be soon. Would be bad to walk him, guys, just saying. Just saying. Don't walk him, please. No walk, no walk. We can survive a whole rotation. Yeah, 8. We might be able to survive a rotation and have like 600 chips left over. Would be hilarious. Oh! All in wagering. No low, please. Keep it up, keep it up, King! 4. Oh, wow. 31's in trouble. He is being shown the door with his last 108 chips. That's going to be a nightmare if he survives his next hand. Only because he's probably going to ladder up with like 50 chips. He makes pair. Uh-oh. What's going to happen? Yep. Oh my gosh. That's what happens when there's no anti-tournament. But like I said, I can do the same thing and survive with chips. So we're gonna take that route. The ICM consideration is so weird in this game because of the limit, and because the limits are so high, it's just so strange. It's so foreign to me. 31 should be folding like 100% of hands. If he cares anything about ICM. He can make money by not playing any hands. As can I, so I will survive another $2,000 hit to my stack. Let these guys duke it out, hopefully someone busts out. Didn't really happen last rotation, except for the guy to my left. Man. Maybe I should have went with that ace-3 hand earlier when I had like the ace-5 diamond on. I don't know, I really need to do some studying on this limit high-low thing. Especially where the blinds go up so quickly. Yeah, the other thing, okay. If 5 raises, we're gonna hold. Yes. Alright, maybe fold, we'll have to sit call. That is no fair. That's fair. That's just fair. Oh my goodness. Alright. Oh my gosh, he freaking survived. That doesn't really matter, right?
Because if the blind hits him, he's dead.
Ooh, which is a good hand.
Are we gonna go out, Nate? I know I said I could fold and win some money, but I also want some chips. Is $1.75 bladder more important, or is having the chips to win the 100 worth for 100? If I bust, I bust. But it's fine. Low cards. Oh, I think I'm dead. Next. Yeah. Yep. That's fine. $14 locked up. Alright, so where's the final hand? Let's see this. Aces versus Jacks? Ooh, that'd be interesting. We were drawing real bad against this guy. But I will say that if this 3 was a different card, we would have had a pretty good low draw. Unfortunately, we paired the 3, so we were drawing only. Or, I don't know, were we drawing to more than just a 3? We were drawing to a king, which made us 2 pair. We were drawing to a 9? A 9 would have made us 2 pair? Yeah, I mean, we had very few outs. We actually picked up more outs when the 10 came. And he cleaned. Unfortunate to bust out there, but that's okay. I think my hand was too close to just be folding. Like I said, 33, 31 is just gonna like survive 600 chips in some hilarious. But yeah, that's alright. 2 final tables, 1 Saturday morning. I think we did good. It was a long ass stream. Didn't go that long, but we did pick up some greenbacks. If you're watching, you saw the whole thing. Your name is Daniel Lepikowski. You're the man. Thanks for watching. I'm checking out. I should probably get something to eat. Peace, guys. Look at this. 31. Now he's on. Actually, I'm interested to see if he survives this one. Probably dead. He has an 8. You gotta dodge a 10. Yeah. Wow. Chip in the chair.